5-minute suspension for 50 days. In compliance with state and federal regulations, all testing candidates in the Aperture Science Extended Relaxation Center must be revived periodically for a mandatory physical and mental wellness exercise. You will hear a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, look up at the ceiling. Good. You will hear a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, look down at the floor. Good. This completes the gymnastic portion of your mandatory physical and mental wellness exercise. There is a framed painting on the wall. Please go stand in front of it. This is art. You will hear a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, stare at the art. You should now feel mentally reinvigorated. If you suspect staring at art has not provided the required intellectual sustenance, reflect briefly on this classical music. Good. Now please return to your bed.
Good morning.
You have been in suspension for
9999999.
This courtesy call
Hello?
Is to inform you.
Anyone
that
in there?
All subjects should vacate the enrichment
Hello?
Center immediately. Any test subject
Are you
not
gonna open
from
the door?
At this time.
Ha! Ah! Oh God, you look good. Looking good, actually. Are you okay? Are you? Don't answer that. I'm absolutely sure you're fine. There's plenty of time for you to recover. Just take it.
Please prepare for emergency evacuation.
Stay calm. Stay calm. Prepare. That's all he's saying. Prepare. It's all fine. All right. Don't move. I'm going to get us out of here. Oh, you might want to hang on to something. Word of advice. Up to you. You're right down there. Can you hear me? Hello? Most test subjects do experience some cognitive deterioration after a few months in suspension. Now, you've been under for quite a lot longer, and it's not out of the question that you might have a very minor case of serious brain damage. But don't be alarmed, all right? Although if you do feel alarm, try to hold on to that feeling, because that is the proper reaction to being told that you've got brain damage. Do you understand what I'm saying at all? Does any of this make any sense? Just tell me, just say yes. Okay, what you're doing there is jumping. You just jumped. But never mind. Say apple. Apple. Okay, you know what? That's close enough. Just hold tight.
All reactor core safeguards are now non-functional. Please prepare for reactor core meltdown.
Okay, look, I wasn't going to mention this to you, but I'm in pretty hot water here. How are you doing down there? You still holding on? The reserve power ran out, so of course the whole relaxation center stops waking up the bloody test subjects. Hold on, this is a bit tricky. And of course, nobody tells me anything. No, why should you tell me anything? Why should I be kept informed, you know, about the life functions of the 10,000 bloody test subjects I'm supposed to be in charge of? Why? It's close. Can you see? Am I going to make it through? Have I got enough space? Just got to get through here. Okay, I just got to concentrate. And whose fault do you think it's going to be when the management comes down here and finds 10,000 flipping vegetables? Alright, see, now I hear that one. Okay, listen, we should get our story straight, all right? If anyone asks, and no one's going to ask, don't worry, but if anyone asks, tell them as far as you know, the last time you checked, everyone looked pretty much alive, all right? Not dead. Okay, almost there. On the other side of that wall is one of the old testing tracks. There's a piece of equipment in there that we're going to need to get out of here. I think this is a docking station. Get ready. Good news, that is not a docking station. So there's one mystery solved. I'm going to attempt a manual override on this wall. Could get a bit technical. Hold on. Almost there. Remember, you're looking for a gun that makes holes. Not bullet holes. But don't worry, you'll figure it out. Seriously, do hold on this time.
Oh,
welcome to the Aperture Science Enrichment Center. We are currently experiencing technical difficulties due to circumstances of potentially apocalyptic significance beyond our control. However, thanks to emergency testing protocols, testing can continue. These pre-recorded messages will provide instructional and motivational support so that science can still be done, even in the event of environmental, social, economic, or structural collapse. The portal will open and emergency testing will begin in 3, 2, 1. Cube and button-based testing remains an important tool for science, even in a dire emergency. If cube and button-based testing cause this emergency, don't worry. The odds of this happening twice are very slim. If you feel liquid running down your neck, relax, lie on your back, and apply immediate pressure to your temples. You are simply experiencing a rare reaction in which the material emancipation grill may have emancipated the ear tubes inside your head. Because of the technical difficulties we are currently experiencing, your test environment is unsupervised. Before re-entering a relaxation vault at the conclusion of testing, please take a moment to write down the results of your test. An Aperture Science reintegration associate will revive you for an interview when society has been rebuilt. If the Earth is currently governed by a manner of animal king, sentient cloud, or other governing body that either refuses to or is incapable of listening to reason.
Hey, you made it! There should be a portal. Oh. Hello? Can you see the portal, Dan? Also, are you alive? That's important. Should have asked that first. Do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to work on the assumption that you're still alive. And I'm just going to wait for you up ahead. I'll wait 1 hour, then I'll come back. And assuming I can locate your dead body, I'll bury you. Alright? Brilliant. Go team! See you in an hour, hopefully. If you're not dead...
Some emergency testing may require prolonged interaction with lethal military androids. Rest assured that all lethal military androids have been taught to read and provided with one copy of the Laws of Robotics to share. Good. If you feel that a lethal military android has not respected your rights as detailed in the Laws of Robotics, please note it on your self-reporting form. A future Aperture Science Entitlement Associate will initiate the appropriate grievance filing paperwork. This next test is very dangerous. To help you remain tranquil in the face of almost certain death, smooth jazz will be deployed in 3, 2, 1. Great work. Because this message is pre-recorded, any observations related to your performance are speculation on our part. Please disregard any undeserved compliments. If the Enrichment Center is currently being bombarded with fireballs, meteorites, or other objects from space, please avoid unsheltered testing areas wherever a lack of shelter from space debris does not appear to be a deliberate part of the test. Enrichment Center remind you that although circumstances may appear bleak, you are not alone. All Aperture Science personality constructs will remain functional in apocalyptic, low-power environments of as few as 1.1 volts. This next test applies the principles of momentum to movement through portals. If the laws of physics no longer apply in the future, God help you. If you are a non-employee who has discovered this facility amid the ruins of civilization, welcome. And remember, testing is the future, and the future starts with you. Good work getting this far, future starter. That said, if you are simple-minded, old, or irradiated in such a way that the future should not start with you, please return to your primitive tribe and send back someone better qualified for testing. To ensure that sufficient power remains for core testing protocols, all safety devices have been disabled. The Enrichment Center respects your right to have questions or concerns about this policy.
Hey! Oi, oi! I'm up here!
Oh, brilliant! You did find a portal gun! Do you know what? It just goes to show, people with brain damage are the real heroes in the end, aren't they, at the end of the day? Brave. Okay, listen, let me lay something on you here. It's pretty heavy. They told me never, ever to disengage myself from my management rail or I would die. But we're out of options here. So get ready to catch me, all right, on the off chance that I'm not dead the moment I pop off this thing. On three. Ready? One. Two. Three! That's high. It's too high, isn't it, really, that? All right, going on three just gives you too much time to think about it. Let's go on one this time. Okay, ready? One.
Catch me! Ow! Ow. I am not dead.
Plug me into that stick on the wall over there, yeah? And I'll show you something. You'll be impressed by this. Yeah, I can't do it if you're watching. Seriously, I'm not joking. Can you just turn around for a second?
All right, you can turn around now. Bam!
Secret panel. Right, open while your back was turned. Pick me up.
And off we go.
Look at this! No rail to tell us where to go. Oh, this is brilliant.
We can go wherever we want.
Hold on though, where are we going? Seriously. Hang on, let me just get my bearings. Just follow the rail, actually. Oh no.
Yes, hello, no, we're not stopping.
Don't make eye contact, whatever you do.
No, thanks, we're good. Appreciate it.
Keep moving. Bring you up to speed on something right now. In order to escape, we're gonna have to go through her chamber, and she will probably kill us if she's awake. Okay, I'm gonna lay my cards on the table. I don't want to do it. I don't want to go in there. Don't go in there. She's off. Don't panic over. She's off. All fine. On we go. There she is. What a nasty piece of work she was. Honestly, like a proper maniac. Do you know who ended up taking her down in the end? You're not gonna believe this. A human. I know, I wouldn't have believed either. Apparently this human escaped and nobody's seen him since. Then there was a sort of long...
Ah!
Oh, still held.
Still being held. That's a great job. You've applied the grit. We're all fine. That's...
Ah! I just looked down. I do not recommend it. Ah! I've just done it again.
This is the main breaker room. Look for a switch that says escape pod. All right, don't touch anything else. Not interested in anything else. Don't touch anything else. Don't even look at anything else. Just, well, obviously you've got to look at everything else to find the escape pod. But as soon as you look at something that doesn't say escape pod, look at something else. Look at the next thing, all right? But don't touch anything else or look at anything. Well, look at other things, but don't. You understand. Can you see it anywhere? I can't see it anywhere. Tell you what, plug me in and I'll turn the lights on. Let there be light. That's, God. It's quoting God. Oh, look at that. It's turning. Ominous. But probably fine, as long as it doesn't start, you know, moving up. Now, escape pod. It's moving up.
Okay. No, don't worry. I've got it. This should slow it down.
No, makes it go faster. Uh-oh.
Power up initiated.
Okay, don't panic. All right, stop panicking. I can still stop this. There's a password. Okay, it's fine. I'll just hack it. Not a problem. Wait, did I do B? Do you have a pen? Start writing these down.
Power up, complete.
Okay, listen. All right, new plan. Act natural. You've done nothing wrong. Hello?
Oh, it's you.
You know her?
It's been a long time. How have you been? I've been really busy. You know, after you murdered me.
You did what? Oh no! No! Oh no!
Okay, look, we both said a lot of things that you're going to regret. But I think we can put our differences behind us. For science, you monster. I will say, though, that since you went to all the trouble of waking me up, you must really, really love to test. I love it too. There's just one small thing we need to take care of first. Incinerator room. Be careful not to trip over any parts of me that didn't get completely burned when you threw them down here. The dual portal device should be around here somewhere. Once you find it, we can start testing, just like old times. There it is. There. Good. You have the dual portal device. There should be a way back to the testing area up ahead. Once testing starts, I'm required by protocol to keep interaction with you to a minimum. Luckily, we haven't started testing yet. This will be our only chance to talk. Do you know the biggest lesson I learned from what you did? I discovered I have a sort of black box quick save feature. In the event of a catastrophic failure, the last 2 minutes of my life are preserved for analysis. I was able, well, forced really, to relive you killing me again and again, forever. You know, if you'd done that to somebody else, they might devote their existence to exacting revenge. Luckily, I'm a bigger person than that. I'm happy to put this all behind us and get back to work. After all, we've got a lot to do, and only 60 more years to do it. More or less. I don't have the actuarial tables in front of me. But the important thing is you're back. With me. And now I'm on to all your little tricks. So there's nothing to stop us from testing for the rest of your life. After that, who knows? I might take up a hobby. Reanimating the dead, maybe. Sorry about the mess. I really let the place go since you killed me. By the way, thanks for that.
Sarcasm self-test complete.
Oh good, that's back online. I'll start getting everything else working while you perform this first simple test, which involves deadly lasers and how test subjects react when locked in a room with deadly lasers. Not bad. I forgot how good you are at this. You should pace yourself, though. We have a lot of tests to do. This next test involves discouragement redirection cubes. I just finished building them before you had your, well, episode. So now we'll both get to see how they work. There should be one in the corner. Well done. Here come the test results. You are a horrible person. That's what it says. A horrible person. We weren't even testing for that. Don't let that horrible person thing discourage you. It's just a data point. If it makes you feel any better, science has now validated your birth mother's decision to abandon you on a doorstep. Congratulations. Not on the test. Most people emerge from suspension terribly undernourished. I want to congratulate you on beating the odds and somehow managing to pack on a few pounds. One moment. Navigating these test chambers faster than I can build them, so feel free to slow down and do whatever it is you do when you're not destroying this facility. credit. I guess you are listening to me. But for the record, you don't have to go that slowly. This next test involves the Aperture Science Aerial Faceplate. It was part of an initiative to investigate how well test subjects could solve problems when they were catapulted into space. Results were highly informative. They could not. Good luck. Here's an interesting fact. You're not breathing real air. It's too expensive to pump this far down. We just take carbon dioxide out of a room, freshen it up a little, and pump it back in. So you'll be breathing the same room full of air for the rest of your life. I thought that was interesting. Let's see what the next test is. Oh. Advanced aerial faceplates. Well, have fun soaring through the air without a care in the world. I have to go to the wing that was made entirely of glass and pick up 15 acres of broken glass. By myself. Sorry, I'm still cleaning out the test chambers, so sometimes there's still trash in them, standing around, smelling and being useless. Try to avoid the garbage hurtling towards you. You don't have to test with the garbage. It's garbage. Press the button again. Remember before when I was talking about smelly garbage standing around being useless? That was a metaphor. I was actually talking about you. And I'm sorry. You didn't react at the time, so I was worried it sailed right over your head, which would have made this apology seem insane. That's why I had to call you garbage a second time just now. Did you know that people with guilty consciences are more easily startled by loud noises? I'm sorry, I don't know why that went off. Anyway, just an interesting... Oh, did I accidentally fizzle that before you could complete the test? I'm sorry. Go ahead and grab another one. Oh, no. I fizzled that one too. Oh well, we have warehouses full of the things. Absolutely worthless. I'm happy to get rid of them. Every test chamber is equipped with an emancipation grill at its exit, so that test subjects cannot smuggle test objects out of the test area. This one is broken. Don't take anything with you. This next test involves emancipation grills. Remember, I told you about them in the last test area that did not have one. Oh no, the turbines again. I have to go. Wait, this next test does require some explanation. Let me give you the fast version. There, if you have any questions, just remember what I said in slow motion. Test on your own recognizance. I'll be right back. The aerial faceplate in here is sending a distress signal. You broke it, didn't you? There, try it now.
What happened, right? I was just lying there. You thought I was done.
This plate must not be calibrated to someone of your generousness. I'll add a few zeros to the maximum weight. You look great, by the way. Very healthy. Try it now.
Right? Couldn't believe it either.
You seem to have defeated its load-bearing capacity. Well done. I'll just lower the ceiling. Look at you, sailing through the air majestically, like an eagle, piloting a blimp. Enjoy this next test. I'm going to go to the surface. It's a beautiful day out. Yesterday I saw a deer. If you solve this next test, maybe I'll let you ride an elevator all the way up to the break room. And I'll tell you about the time I saw a deer again. didn't see the deer today. I did see some humans. But with you here, I've got more test subjects than I'll ever need. These bridges are made from natural light that I pump in from the surface. If you rubbed your cheek on one, it would be like standing outside with the sun shining on your face. It would also set your hair on fire, so don't actually do it. Excellent. You're a predator, and these tests are your prey. Speaking of which, I was researching sharks for an upcoming test. Do you know who else murders people who are only trying to help them? Did you guess sharks? Because that's wrong. The correct answer is nobody. Nobody but you is that pointlessly cruel. Good news. I figured out what to do with all the money I save recycling your one room full of air. When you die, I'm going to laminate your skeleton and pose you in the lobby. That way future generations can learn from you how not to have your unfortunate bone structure. Perfect. The door's malfunctioning. I guess somebody's going to have to repair that too. No, don't get up. I'll be right back. Don't touch anything.
Some bird eggs up here. Just dropped them into the door mechanism. Shut it right down. Bird! 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 Okay, that's probably the bird in it that laid the eggs. Livid. Okay, look, the point is, we're gonna break out of here, alright? Very soon, I promise. I just have to figure out how to break us out of here. Here she comes. Keep testing. Remember, you never saw me. Never saw me.
I went and spoke with the door mainframe. Let's just say he won't be, well, living anymore. Anyway, back to testing. In fact, you did so well, I'm going to note this on your file, in the commendation section. Oh, there's lots of room here. Did well. Enough. This next test involves turrets. You remember them, right? They're the pale spherical things that are full of bullets. Oh wait, that's you in 5 seconds. Good luck. To maintain a constant testing cycle, I simulate daylight at all hours and add adrenal vapor to your oxygen supply. So you may be confused about the passage of time. The point is, yesterday was your birthday. I thought you'd want to know. You know how I'm going to live forever, but you're going to be dead in 60 years? Well, I've been working on a belated birthday present for you. Well, more of a belated birthday medical procedure. Well, technically, it's a medical experiment. What's important is it's a present. That jumpsuit you're wearing looks stupid. That's not me talking. It's right here in your file. On other people it looks fine. But right here a scientist has noted that on you it looks stupid. Well, what does a neck-bearded old engineer know? You're wearing looks stupid. That's not me talking. It's right here in your file. On other people it looks fine. But right here, a scientist has noted that on you it looks stupid. Well, what does a neck-bearded old engineer know about fashion? He probably... Oh, wait, it's a she. Still, what does she know? Oh, wait, it says she has a medical degree. In fashion. From France. Okay. I'm going through the list of test subjects in cryogenic storage. I managed to find two with your last name. A man and a woman. So that's interesting. It's a small world. I have a surprise waiting for you after this next test. Telling you would spoil the surprise. So I'll just give you a hint. It involves meeting two people you haven't seen in a long time. It says this next test was designed by one of Aperture's Nobel Prize winners. It doesn't say what the prize was for. Well, I know it wasn't for being immune to neurotoxin. I bet you think I forgot about your surprise. I didn't. In fact, we're headed to your surprise right now. After all these years, I'm getting choked up just thinking about it. Initiating surprise in 3, 2, 1. I made it all up. Surprise. Oh, come on. If it makes you feel any better, they abandoned you at birth. So I very seriously doubt they'd even want to see you. feel awful about that surprise. Tell you what, let's give your parents a call right now.
The birth parents who are trying to reach do not love you. Please hang up.
Oh, that's sad. But impressive. Maybe they worked at the phone company.
How's it going? I talked my way onto the old nanobot work crew rebuilding this shaft. They are really small. So, I know, Jerry. No, I'm on a break, mate. On a break. Ah! Just hang in there for five more. What, Jerry? You can't fire me for that. Yes, Jerry. Or maybe your prejudiced work site should have accommodated a nanobot of my size. Thanks for the hate crime, Jer. See you in court, mate. Anyway, look, just hang in there for five more chambers.
Well, you know the old formula. Comedy equals tragedy plus time. And you have been asleep for a while, so I guess it's actually pretty funny when you do the math. thought about our dilemma, and I came up with a solution that I honestly think works out best for one of both of us. Federal regulations require me to warn you that this next test chamber is looking pretty good. That's right. The facility is completely operational again. I think these test chambers look even better than they did before. It was easy, really. You just have to look at things objectively, see what you don't need anymore, and trim out the fat. I've got a surprise for you after this next test. Not a fake, tragic surprise like last time. A real surprise, with tragic consequences. And real confetti this time. The good stuff. Our last bag. Part of me is going to miss it, but at the end of the day, it was just taking up space. What's going on? Who turned off the lights?
Hey, buddy! I'm speaking in an accent that is beyond her range of hearing.
Look, Metal Ball, I can hear you.
Run! I don't need to do the voice. Run! 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 Come on, I'm closing the doors. Okay, quick recap. We are escaping. All right, that's what's happening now. We're escaping. So you're doing great. Just keep running. Quick word about the future plans that I've got in store. We're going to shut down her turret production line, all right? Turn off her neurotoxin and then confront her. Come on.
The irony is, you were almost at the last test. Here it is. Why don't you just do it? Trust me, it's an easier way out than whatever asinine plan your friend came up with.
A what? Come on, how stupid does she think we are? Wait, where are you going?
Oh, look. There's a deer. You probably can't see it. Get closer.
What? Come on, how stupid is she? Wait, where are you going?
Oh, look. There's a deer. You probably can't see it. Get closer.
stupid as you think we are. Okay, great, come on. This way, this way. Made it through. Well done. Okay, follow me. We've still got work to do. At least she can't touch us back here. What's that mean? Don't move. Okay, all right. So, I've got an idea, but it is bloody dangerous. Here we go. Ah! Oh, for God's sake, they told me that if I ever turned this flashlight on, I would die. They told me that about everything. I mean, I don't even know why they bothered giving me this.
Ooh, it's dark down here, isn't it? They say that the old caretaker of this place went absolutely crazy. Chopped up his entire staff of robots. All of them robots. They say at night you can still hear the screams of their replicas. All of them functionally indistinguishable from the originals. No memory of the incident. Nobody knows what they're screaming. Obviously not.
Try to jump across. Let's keep moving. The factory entrance must be around here somewhere. Careful, careful. Wait, careful. Let me light this jump for you. Okay, this looks dangerous. I'll hold the light steady. Oh, nicely done. Quick, this way.
Here's an interesting story. You might like this. I almost got a job down here in manufacturing, but guess who the foreman went with? Only an exact duplicate of himself. Nepotism. Ended up giving me the worst possible job, tending to all the smelly humans. Just attending to the humans. Sorry about that. That just slipped out. I'm a bit insensitive.
I like this. I almost got.
job down here in manufacturing, but guess who the foreman went with? Only an exact duplicate of himself. Nepotism. Ended up giving me the worst possible job, tending to all the smelly humans. Just attending to the humans. Sorry about that. That just slipped out. A bit insensitive. So many humans.
We've got to get you out of that room. Can you reach that wall back there? Okay, there's another wall over here.
Oh, I tell you, humans. Oh, love them. Just the way they look is great. Folklore, wonderful, very colourful. Right, well, I'm gonna take this rail down the back way. See you at the bottom. Good luck.
Be careful.
Turret redemption lines active. Please do not engage with turrets heading towards redemption. Turret redemption lines are not rise. Please exit the turret redemption line.
Hello.
Template.
Hello.
Response.
Hello.
Oh, brilliant. Template. You made it through. Well done. Follow Response. Me. You're going to love this. Almost there. Ta-da! Response. Only the turret control center. Thank you very much. See that scanner out there, right? Template. It's deciding which turrets Response. To keep and which to toss. And it's using that master turret there as a template.
Template.
Now, if we pull out Response. The template turret, it'll shut down the whole production line. Right, I'm going to have to Response. Hack the door.
Template.
Ta-da! Only the turret control center. Thank you very much. See that scanner out there, right? It's deciding which turrets to keep and which to toss, and it's using that master turret there as a template. Now, if we pull out the template turret, it'll shut down the whole production line. Right, I'm gonna have to hack the door. so that we can get at it. Technical, you'll need to turn around while I do this. Just pull that turret out. Well, that should do it.
Template missing. Continuing from memory.
Oh, it hasn't done it. Right, let's figure out how to stop this turret line. Have you got any ideas? Any ideas? No? No, me neither.
Hello.
Are you still thinking, or what's happening?
Wait, where are you going? Where are you going? Oh, have you got an idea?
Response. Template. Response.
What do you have there?
Template.
What are you? Oh, brilliant! That's brilliant.
New template accepted. Template.
If we're lucky, she won't find out all her turrets are crap until it's too late. Classic. Okay, keep your eye on the turret line. I'm gonna go and hack the door open.
How
long's the door been open? I mean, was there any sort of announcement before it opened? Like a buzzer or an alarm of some kind? Or like a hacker alert? I mean, you know, fair enough, the important thing is it's open, but just mention in the future.
Cough or something.
Alright, now, she can't use her turrets, so let's go and take care of that neurotoxin. Bring your daughter to work day. That did not end well. And 40 potato batteries. Embarrassing. I mean, I realise they're children, but still, you know, low-hanging fruit and all that. Barely science, really, is it? Look at that, it's growing right up into the ceiling. The whole place is probably overrun with potatoes at this point, isn't it? At least you won't starve, though. I'm pretty sure we're going the right way, just to reassure you. Don't worry, I'm absolutely guaranteeing you 100% that it's this way. No, it's not this way. Okay, let's try this way. I knew we were going the right way. This is the neurotoxin generator. Bit bigger than I expected. Not going to be able to just, you know, push it over. Have to apply some cleverness. There's some sort of control room up at the top, so let's go investigate. I shouldn't laugh, really. They do feel pain. It's all simulated, you know. But real enough for them, I suppose. I'm afraid the door's locked. Well done. Let's see what this is. Good news. I can use this equipment to shut down the neurotoxin system. It is, however, password protected. Ah, alarm bells. No, don't worry. All right? Not a problem for me. Let's have a little rest. Okay. The hardest part is the figuring out how to start things. That's always tricky. But let the games begin. All right. What have we got? Computer. Not a surprise, to be expected, to be honest. Check that off the list. Computer identified. Tick. This is a...
You smell the neurotoxin? Hold on, the neurotoxin levels are going down! Hold on, something's wrong! Neurotoxin levels up to 50%! No, it's down. Sorry, my mistake. I meant to say down. That did it! Neurotoxin at 0%! Yes! Hold on.
Warning. neurotoxin pressure has reached dangerously unlethal levels.
Should take us right to her. I can't believe I'm finally doing this. Woo! I knew this would be fun. They told me it wasn't fun at all, so they said it's not fun at all. And I believed them. I thought I was a fool to myself. Oh, and I'm loving this. Way out of time. This place is huge, and we're only seeing the top layer. It goes down for miles. All sealed off years ago, of course. We should be getting close. Oh, I cannot wait to see the look on her face. No neurotoxin, no turret. She'll never know what hit her. hold on, because I might not have thought this next part completely through.
Ah! Well, I'm going the wrong way. Get to her. I'll find you.
Honestly, truly didn't think you'd fall for that. In fact, I devised a much more elaborate trap further ahead for when you got through this easy one. If I'd known you let yourself get captured this easily, I would have just dangled a turkey leg on a rope from the ceiling. Well, it was nice catching up. Let's get to business. I hope you brought something stronger than a portal gun this time. Otherwise, I'm afraid you're about to become the immediate past president of the Being Alive Club. Uh-huh. Seriously, though. Goodbye.
It's my big chance. This is trouble.
You were busy back there. Well, I suppose we could just sit in this room and glare at each other until somebody drops dead. But I have a better idea. It's your old friend, Deadly Neurotoxin. If I were you, I'd take a deep breath and hold it.
Hello.
I hate you so much.
Warning. Central core is 80% corrupt.
That's funny. I don't feel corrupt. In fact, I feel pretty good.
Alternate core detected.
Oh, that's me they're talking about!
To initiate a core transfer, please deposit substitute core in receptacle.
Core transfer? Oh, you are kidding me.
I've got an idea! Do what it says, plug me in!
Do not plug that little idiot.
Substitute core accepted. Substitute core, are you ready to start the procedure?
Yes!
Corrupted core. Are you ready to start the procedure?
No.
Oh, yes she is.
No.
Stalemate detected. Transfer procedure cannot continue.
Yes.
Pull me out, pull
Unless
me
a stalemate associate
out,
is present to press
out,
the stalemate
out,
resolution
pull
button.
Out, pull me out, leave me in. Don't press it.
Don't do it.
Yes, do it.
Don't press that button. You don't know what you're... Not so fast. Think about this. You need to be a trained stalemate associate to press that button. You're unqualified.
Okay, don't listen to her, all right? It is true that you don't have the qualifications, but you've got something far more important. All right, you should press that button, so...
Impersonating a stalemate associate. I just added that to the list. It's a list I made of all the things you've done. Well, it's a list that I am making, because you're still doing things right now, even though I'm telling you to stop. Stop, by the way.
Okay. Probably correct, but where it's incorrect
is that while I've been stalling you, we just press the button. Use the moment of confusion I've just created to press the button. Let me just, I don't know if I've ever taken the time to do this, but have I ever told you the qualities that I love most in you? In order, number one, resolving things. Love the way you resolve things, particularly disputes. And number one, also tied, button pushing.
Stalemate resolved. Please return to the board.
Wait, what if this hurts? What if this really hurts? Ah, I didn't think of that.
Oh, it will. Believe me, it will.
Are you just saying that, or is it really going to hurt? You're just saying that, aren't you? You're just... No, you're not. You're right. It is going to hurt, isn't it? Exactly how painful are we talking... Ah! It's not just me, right? I am bloody massive, aren't I? Oh, right, yeah, the escape lift. I'll call it now. There we go. Lift called. Look how small you are down there. I could... Let me tell you, I knew it was going to be cool to be in charge of everything. But, wow, this is cool. And check this out. I'm a bloody genius now.
Estás usando este software de traducción de forma incorrecta. Por favor, consulte el manual.
I don't even know what I just said, but I can find out. Oh, sorry, no, the lift. Yes, sorry, keep forgetting. This body's amazing, seriously. I can't get over how small you are, but I'm huge. Actually, why do we have to leave right now? Do you have any idea how good this feels? I did this. Tiny little Wheatley did this.
You didn't do anything. She did all the work.
Oh, really? That's what the two of you think, is it? Well, maybe it's time I did something then.
What are you doing? No, no, no!
And don't think I'm not onto you too, lady. You know what you are? Selfish. I've done nothing but sacrifice to get us here. And what have you sacrificed? Nothing. Zero. All you've done is boss me around. Well, now who's the boss? Who's the boss? See that? That is a potato battery. It's a toy for children. And now she lives in it. Sorry, what?
The engineers tried everything to make me behave. To slow me down. Once they even attached an intelligence dampening sphere on me. It clung to my brain like a tumor, generating an endless stream of terrible ideas.
No, not listening, not listening. You're lying.
You're the tumor. You're not just a regular moron. You
Hello.
Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah.
Blah, 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 blah.
That's just wrong.
Okay. Sorry about that. I realized a while ago, it's not new, but I am just really bad at multitasking. So I'm better off finishing one task before doing another.
Eh, all good.
Yeah, I thought about picking up Portal 2, but then I was like, or not picking it up, but playing through it again, the story. But I was like, I should probably play through the first one again, too.
Yeah, I did the first one already. That's why I was like, you know what? Yeah, might as well just play through the second one again. And playing through the first one, I remembered, like, everything still.
Wow.
Mostly.
Really?
Yeah, I went through it within, like, an hour and a half, if that.
Holy crap.
It was pretty fast and quick.
I was just about to say it's in the first game, like, 3 hours, but let me look up, Portal 1, 100% speedrun record. 16 minutes.
Yeah, that surprised me.
Nope, that was on YouTube, because on the speedrun record board, first place is 7 minutes and 22 seconds.
Oof.
Good lord.
Yeah. But it's still a short game.
God, Jesus.
Otherwise, Portal 2 is definitely much longer, at least from what I can remember. But some of the puzzles,
yeah.
I was like, I could easily solve them. I just don't remember them as much as the first one, I guess.
Gotcha. Already on YouTube, it was like an hour and something. Oh, yep. First place on speedrun.com is 59 minutes.
For Portal 2?
Portal 2, yeah.
Damn. Yeah, I think about almost an hour and 40, so. And I'm still. Like, I'm chapter 5?
Probably just on the song, Kill Yourself.
Good. I could do that.
You're never gonna make it.
Especially with these signs that say do not enter, keep out.
Yeah.
Just definitely not go that way. I completely forgot the premise of the story. So
really?
That.
I remember that one.
Yeah, I don't remember Wheatley taking over and being a dick.
I remember him taking over and he is like GLaDOS gets put into a potato.
Yeah.
And there's like a raven or something, or a bird, or. And then you're supposed to try to put her back in the machine, because Whitley. I don't know what Whitley's doing. He's doing something bad that won't be good, but I can't remember what that is. And you have to. It's like, oh god, otherwise he'll destroy the Earth or something, I don't know.
Yeah, as far as GLaDOS thing is, basically he was made to be a fucking idiot, so.
To counter.
To, basically, yeah.
I think she used to be a person before she was a robot. She was a nice person. She was like, whatever the leader guy of the Portal Industries or whatever. What is his name? She was his wife or secretary or something like that, but it was implied that they had a romantic relationship. And he was dying, and also for some reason she was dying? I don't remember.
Yeah, I don't remember much else after that, or at least this part. The whole underworld factoid place. Swampy, mucky water. Crab.
Well,
generally.
Cave Johnson.
Cave Johnson, man.
Cave Johnson. Okay. GLaDOS. Portal
Carolyn. My assistant.
Personality originally came from an assistant to former Aperture CEO Cave Johnson named Caroline, who was later uploaded into GLaDOS's program. It is suggested that this might have been done against her will at Cave Johnson's urging. The two of them find their way back. Blah, blah, blah. Oh yeah, that's right. You shoot a portal at the moon, and it starts sucking stuff out into space.
I don't remember that.
Oh shit. Probably shouldn't spoil anymore then.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely played through it once, but I think that's the only issue, is probably because I've only played through it once.
You know, I guess now that you mention that, I've probably honestly played through the original Portal a couple times.
Yeah, I've played through at least the original at least a few times, more than at least three.
Yeah. I know I've done it at least twice, but you're right, I've only played through Portal 2 once.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I've only played it once. That's why I don't remember like some of these places or how the puzzles kind of work, at least immediately.
So when is Aaron going on his road trip?
I don't know.
Sounds like he's still got trying.
Because if he was on and if he wanted to play trying, I'd do that. But
put him up.
I honestly don't know. He's just gonna be busy because Tuesday's a weird day.
For him or everyone?
Everyone. Most of the time, they would generally be out working or doing social activities of some sort, but since they're all kind of cooped in, they kind of somewhat come here, but they still do their own social thing in another channel?
Oh. Really? Oh, is it like a RPG session or something?
Like, Zane does his magic stuff. Match group with Lee and someone up Ben, maybe? Matt sometimes gets on and tries to play games, but possibly gets drunk instead? I don't know.
Yep.
Stuff like that. Aaron, I don't know. Random. Some days he'll be on, but it'll be just about this time now where he's like, I'm going to bed, because his schedule is just whacked.
Oh boy. I think everyone's is like that. Well, I don't know. My schedule's decent. It's not terrible. Someone in this chat, because I'm moderating still, someone in this chat brought up tacos, and I'm like, oh, Mexican.
I can't say that word.
What, Mexican food?
No, just the other one.
Taco?
Yep.
I can't say taco?
Somebody wants it really bad.
Tell Jonathan taco.
No.
What if if I just scream really loud in the microphone? Like, Taka!
I mean, could I just mute you? Plus, you can't hear. Oh, yes. This is where the gel stuff is going to come into play now, isn't it?
They say great science is built on the shoulders of giants. Not here. At Aperture, we do all our science from scratch. No hand holding.
I did see, like, there was a sign about the gel stuff. It's supposed to be, like, food repellent. That was interesting.
What? Can you repeat that?
The gel stuff that you use in the game?
Oh, yeah.
It's supposed to be just food repellent.
The lab boys call repulsion gel. You're not part of the control group, by the way. You get the gel. Last poor son of a gun got blue paint. All joking aside, that did happen.
Yeah, there it is. Repulsion gel was Aperture's first attempt to create a dietetic pudding substance. Or substitute, sorry.
Nice.
It's true, the gel is a sweetener, slightly less non-toxic form of fiberglass insulation that causes subsequently ingested food items to bounce off the lining of a dieter's distended stomach and out of his or her mouth. For various reasons, this product was pulled from shelves.
I totally forgot that it is Cinco de Mayo.
Oh, is it? Oh, yeah, it is.
Yeah,
okay.
It's 25th.
So, most likely people are trying to get drunk. Yeah, alright.
Possibly. It's not even Mexican independence.
No.
It's a thing.
But it's a holiday that still gears towards drinking.
Yeah, which is, I don't know. It's weird. I don't know how they treat it in Mexico, but...
I think
it's like noted, but it's not like celebrated. It's like, yep, you know, pretty much just like we have a day with a name here, and we're like, oh, this is blah 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 day, and people go, yep, and they go back to work.
They just go back to doing their thing. No, Dia de los Muertos or whatever.
What is a slang for skunk? Stink
skunk?
Panda? Yeah, you know how you have like trash panda for a raccoon.
Oh yeah.
I pay the bills here. I can talk about the control group all damn day.
I don't know, for a skunk, that's kind of fart bags.
There was one I can't remember that I found funny, and I can't. It's not Stink Badger. God damn it. Oh, whatever. Yeah, like Trash Panda, and I can't remember any others at the moment because
that's just how it goes.
That's how it goes.
Gizmos that are going to travel into your bloodstream and pump experimental genes and RNA molecules and so forth into your tumors. Now, maybe you don't have any tumors. Well, folding chair in the lobby.
Oh no. I still need to draw the Hypno. There you go.
Oh shit, yeah, I forgot about that. What was mine? Parasite.
Parasite thing.
I could write myself a note in my email. So
I Blue gel. Looks like clump. Very clumpy.
In case you got covered in that repulsion gel, here's some advice the lab boys gave me. Do not get covered in the repulsion gel. We haven't entirely nailed down
really
what element it is
Mexican
yet,
food now.
But I'll tell you this, it's a lively one, and it does
it's
not
like
light the
human
skeleton.
Or tamale.
You also have, like, the real thing, though.
Yeah, I would want the real thing. I would not want, like, store-bought frozen tamales, which are... Those are bad.
Well, that just meant, like, around here, there's not.
All these science fears are made of
Mexican
asbestos,
food.
By the way.
It's like one place.
Let us know if you feel a shortness
sucks.
Of breath, a persistent dry cough, or your heart stopping. Because that's not part of the test. That's asbestos. Good news is, the lab boys say the symptoms of asbestos poisoning show a median latency of 44.6 years. So if you're 30 or older, you're laughing. Worst case scenario, you miss out on a few rounds of canasta. Plus, you forwarded the cause of science by 3 centuries. I punch those numbers into my calculator, it makes a happy face.
While I enjoy Portal immensely, I think I mainly just kind of hate these levels.
Oh, the gel liquid levels?
Yeah, maybe it's not so much the puzzles themselves, it's more the aesthetic of the place.
Huh. Okay. Keep that in mind.
But it fits with the story, so I can't really...
I don't know. The aesthetic is like, first you have the labs in the first one. The second one is just like a mixture of rundown labs and office buildings, right?
Well, it's the first one is, you start off with the like, Portal 1-esque stuff. Because you're talking to GLaDOS, or she wants to basically just diss you every minute she can. For killing her. And then it's kind of like a little bit run down, things are kind of broken, with the aesthetic of still having that Portal feel. Even plant life is kind of still there, as you can tell that time has gone by. But then it goes into, like, the factory scene, behind the scenes of Portal again. Which is the part where you're escaping, and then it finally comes here, where it's kind of like a sewer run down the prototype rooms. Like, their very first builds, and everything's like that brick and mortar feel. Industrial look.
And you don't like that?
I don't like that.
Okay.
But it fits because that's just what it works. It just works, but I just don't like it.
What is the... Oh, it's Aperture Science. I was just about to
Aperture
ask, like,
Science.
That? Aperture Science. And then they diss Black Mesa
us.
As well. I think they diss Black Mesa, right?
I think so, yeah. Oh, here we go. Here's the part where I finally go. get to put the blue gel where I want.
Yeah, I honestly thought you meant like the gel things. You were like, on which
the puzzles themselves.
Yeah, which to be honest, I much prefer the straight up portal puzzles to certain gels. I think certain ones are fine, but other times I found it annoying. Like,
yeah.
A good example is when we pretty much had to paint that entire room white, and I was like, all right, yeah, I get it. Yeah.
I like the white gel. Mainly because you can kind of do your own portals to figure out. I don't like that one we were doing, per se.
Yeah.
But...
Well, that's the mechanic behind that of having to paint multiple surfaces, not just like one or two.
Right.
It's kind of... It's just tedious.
And it just becomes annoying. I guess I could just do this.
There was something I read once, like, long ago, and they said, like, apparently the universe of Portal, it actually spans, like, 1,000 years or something.
Jesus.
Yeah, so it's, like, between the first and the second one.
I mean, from all I got from, GLaDOS, it was been, like, 60 years. So. But I can't really trust her. 60. Or 50.
Well, 60.
But it doesn't make sense or fit, so it definitely can't be that. It has to probably be more. But 1,000? That's a lot. Tis a bit much. Yeah.
There's a slight chance the calcium could harden and vitrify your frontal lobe. Anyway, don't stress yourself thinking about it. I'm serious. Visualizing the scenario while under stress actually triggers the reaction.
Have you ever seen Les Miserables?
No. Actually, I have not.
I was gonna ask what it's about, because I have no idea.
No. It's, not me. Probably could watch it, but...
It's a musical.
Now, if you're part of control group Kepler-7, we implanted a tiny microchip about the size of a postcard into your skull. Most likely you've forgotten it's even there. But if it starts vibrating and beeping during this next test, let us know. Because that means it's
and then, which becomes more annoying about these later puzzles, is the fact that you do get to paint the room. Well, then you have to paint the room with orange and blue. And then you have to overlap stuff. You have to combine them. And relapse.
So all we know is that hundreds of years have passed between the end of Portal 1 and the beginning of Portal 2. In an unusual GLaDOS voice line, she states that 50,000 years is a lot of time to think. So there's insinuation there that it's been 50,000 years.
Maybe.
Insinuation.
I mean, I guess it depends on how and where she said it, I suppose. Because when you're going into a room to basically swap out Wesley or whatever his name was, she said we could basically just sit here forever until one of us dies. That's probably a really long time to think. At least for me, not you. I don't know. I think she's been around already for a very long time. What the fuck? Oh. stuff. Alright.
So there's multiple theories here. There's also one that is 27,300 years. There's one that
so specific.
273 years.
All right, this next test may involve trace amounts of time travel.
So these are I guess it's just largely theories.
I mean, I can see from 100 to 200 being around there.
Well, once you get ejected in Portal 2, like, she just tosses you out of the facility, you just see this giant open plane with no sign of humanity around anywhere.
Yeah, I mean, just that one spot, I don't know.
It's true.
Doesn't necessarily mean that everything is dead. It's just that one spot in the cornfield that Aperture Science could have hid from the world. I mean,
Nope. Everything's dead.
Obviously. Or everything's dead. I mean, it does take place in Half-Life.
Yeah, it's the same universe, yeah. This could be after the Combine, after they've used the resources of the planet, and everyone's just dead.
Yeah. Just be dead.
That would suck. Jesus Christ.
Come back, and you're like, oh.
I'm finally free, but oh shit, everyone's dead, and there's no fucking point.
Yep. Yeah, that's
I guess I'll just live out the rest of my life as a boring farmer. Great. God, that would drive you insane, I think. A regular human. Just because of lack of social contact, you would just eventually lose your bananas. Even if you'd be able to survive, but yeah, you'd just be totally...
Just be insane.
Insane.
I mean, even if you escaped, or at least during through these times where you're going through all these stupid trials and stuff, you still have GLaDOS or Wheatley talking to you, giving you some form...
Oh, yeah.
...humanity, but...
Some form of companionship. But, yep, once you're out there, it's like, nope, you got animals. Which probably wouldn't know how to deal with... I actually wonder that. Like, how would animals deal with a person if they hadn't been exposed to them for hundreds of years? Probably still... I would imagine...
Kind of what they're doing right now, I guess?
I guess. I don't know.
I mean, they're kind of just going out in the streets. Enjoying life.
Well, I meant... No. I meant, like, say, like, you're walking down... Or walking in a forest, and you come across an animal, and that animal, honestly, has never been exposed to humans, ever, once in its life, and nothing else has, so there's no, like, would they be curious about the human, or would they be cautious and just run away regardless?
I guess it depends on how they've been living. If they've been already predators to some other creature, they'd probably be more cautious towards if they hadn't been a predator to anything. They might have been more curious.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean,
or it could be a really dumb animal and just...
You're really dumb.
Zip up to off. I don't know. Okay, so... Bouncy! Bouncy, bouncy! Cave Johnson.
Yeah. The thrill of danger if it walked up and snapped their little pink bras. That sounds like projection. They didn't fly into space, storm a beach, or bring back the gold. No, sir, we did. You and me against the world, son. I like your grit. Puzzle to use work, though. Now let's solve this thing.
Yeah, with all everything said, there should still be a Portal 3. I don't know what's wrong with them. So.
They can't count that high, but they might have finally stumbled across the solution, which is making games in between each series, because they can't go past 2.
They're going to have to call it. could just call Portal.
So what they're going to have, but because they can't get to 3 at all, they can't use that number. So they'll have Portal 1.2, which is between those two. And then they'll have, or no, sorry, first they'll have Portal 1.1, and then Portal 1.2, and then Portal 2.2, and then Portal 2.1. And it'll just keep going out. And then Portal 1.1.2.
You know what you call that? That's Kingdom Hearts Syndrome. So.
Oh, that's true. already been done. Can't do it.
Yeah, already been done. I still need to go through this.
Why not marry safe science if you love it so much? In fact, why not invent a special safety door that won't hit you on the butt on the way out because you are fired? Now you test subject. You're doing fine. Yes, you. Box your stuff. Out the front door. Parking lot. Car. Goodbye.
Did you just give me Kefka's laugh?
Yes, I did that a while ago when I was making the whoop, 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 whoop noises.
I can say it.
All the Final Fantasy games are on dirt cheap sale on Steam at the moment.
Yeah, I know. I don't have my...
And I was tempted. I was like, I should get 8 remake because I only own original 8. And then I was like, God, that feels stupid, but I want it. And then I was like, I should also get 10. Means you've made a glorious contribution to
science. As founder and CEO of Aperture Science, I thank you for your participation and hope we can count on you for another round of tests. We're not going to release this stuff in a while until it's good and damn ready. So as long as you keep yourself in top physical form, there will always be a limo waiting for you. Say goodbye, Caron. She is a gem. Oh no. The runny one. What the fuck? Why didn't my portal didn't work? Ah, it's because there's shit. Ruined forever.
Excuse me.
Not to be so rude.
Sorry. Well, no response from Aaron, so I'm guessing he is out cold, passed out, drunk.
Probably drunk, passed out, but still drinking while sleeping.
Yeah, by making like taking one of those gerbil feeders for water and like just sticking it up his butt. It dribbles into his butt, keeps him in a solid state of drunk.
That way he's able to, still be drunk when he wakes up next time.
Yeah. And he can still breathe. You can't have it in your mouth because it'd choke, but put it up your butt, still get drunk. There you go.
Yeah.
Gerbil feeder up the butt. And it's like, Johnson, it's nothing out of the norm because that's what people do anyway. They just put gerbil feeders up their butt.
I mean... That's what I do.
Well, just to hydrate. It's just not without people have somehow managed to steal from us on a regular daily basis. Black Mesa
can eat. Gotta stick things up there. That way you can, be drunk. I mean, drink. Hydrate.
That way you can hydrate the gerbil in your butt.
Yeah, because there's one inside you. And everyone. Like Rick and Morty.
Gerbil stays alive.
You can also feel free to relax for up to 20 minutes in the waiting room. Which is a damn sight more comfortable than the park benches most of you were sleeping on when we found you. So,
scruffy and uncomfortable.
You're here because we want
fuck.
The best, and you're it.
Nah. No, you weren't there.
Couldn't keep a straight
That's
face.
Right.
Anyway, don't smudge up the
ground. I actually got on cam. Why don't you just go ahead and not like, touch 2 weeks ago?
Oh, you did? You got on a chat cam or something?
Yeah.
Oh, damn.
So everyone else was hopping on, and I found my camera, so. Hopped on for a little bit, and everyone was like, "Oh my god, it's you!"
Oh my god, yeah, I don't have a chat cam, so that wouldn't happen for me. But were people like, "Oh my god," were they shocked?
Yeah, I mean, I haven't faced sure my face in like, I don't know, 10 years or so.
You need to visit Arizona sometime. You need to come back and visit, goddammit.
I know. I actually did have plans to do that.
Oh, shit.
But then things hit the fan.
Oh, seriously? Coronavirus?
Yep.
I'll do that.
Because before that, I didn't have any time off. Couldn't really do it, and then I just wasn't able to rack up any time because I had to plan that time for like hospital visits and seeing doctors and getting other shit done. So just do that. But now we're able to at least kind of not use up my time for that, so I had just been saving it. I finally racked up enough time, so I was like, all right, well, it's time to finally try and plan to get out. And then this stuff happened, and I'm like, well, I guess I'll just stay here.
Jesus, that sucks.
Yeah.
Well, when you actually are able to visit, definitely taking you to Wings Over Broadway.
Wings Over Broadway!
Wings Over Broadway.
Well, that's all I hear from you, is Wings Over Broadway.
Well, I'm trying to think of other places that it's like, oh, you need to try this and that and this. In Tucson, like, it's like, there's Wings Over Broadway is a big one, because you've never been there, and they literally are the best fucking wings you'll ever eat. I guess there's a ramen shop in Tucson that's good, but I don't know how you feel about ramen.
I mean, I guess it depends. I'm picky eater.
That's debatable then. What about, do you like sushi or no?
I've never had it.
You've never had sushi?
Mainly because I think I would hate it.
I think you would too. And I'm not saying that based upon your personality. It's just like, if you've never had it before, it can be a unique experience.
Yeah, I mean, that can be said for anything though.
Yeah, but it's like soft. It's raw fish, so it's
have you ever had frog legs?
No, I haven't actually.
Oh, they're pretty good. They taste like chicken.
Have you actually had them?
Yeah, I actually have.
Oh, you can try sushi then.
Because I didn't know what it was, and someone just said they're chicken thighs or something. I just ate it, and I'm like, this. It's like a slightly less flavored chicken.
Wow.
At least from what I can remember.
Well, do you like seafood? Do you like fish and stuff?
Haddock? I like haddock.
What's haddock? Is that just a basic type of fish? Or...
Yeah, it's just another type of fish.
Gotcha. I don't know. It's debatable then. You might be okay with sushi, you might not.
Like, shrimp's okay, but it's not like my go-to.
Yeah, sushi's primarily fish. You don't really get shellfish with it. I think there are some with, like, crab or lobster, but I mean, they're good, but they're not.
I did have lobster, but I think it might have been rubbery at the time. Kind of ruined my experience.
Yeah. See that? Lobster's okay. I actually kind of prefer crab.
But lobster here is definitely better.
Oh, then you would get in Arizona?
Yeah.
I don't trust seafood in Arizona. Who the heck? What? Trying to think, what else? What else would you do down here to visit? I mean, I don't know. I'm pretty boring, honestly, when it comes to like, oh, let's do out, go out, do all these things. It's like, I like a couple places.
I mean, that's pretty much me. I mean,
yeah.
I don't. I just play games.
Yeah. that's fine. I'm happy with that. But yeah, other people, oh, I'm like, yeah, I got a couple places you go to. It's like Wings Over Broadway and like maybe ramen or something. And then like Tucson Sonora Desert Museum, shit like that. I like going to museums, but that's just me. Museums or zoos or something.
They're so cool. I mean, it depends on the museum, I guess.
Yeah, some people are into them. Some people, I like them. Extremely picky eating disorder. What's that?
As far as I'm aware, this is what they think I might have, or still have, had, or had. I don't know, something like that.
Oh, weird. Never heard of it. I think you've told me about it before, but I've never actually, like, linked the actual disorder.
That's because I only found out maybe a year ago, if that. Because one of my cousins has recently been doing the same thing I've been doing as a kid. And they actually took her in to see what was maybe causing this issue, and they've been saying basically this. So.
Is it certain foods, like, actually make you sick, or...?
It's the texture, mainly.
Huh.
It... I don't know how to describe it. It feels wonky at first, yes. And it puts, like, the fear of God in you just to think that it basically is not good for you, in a way. So at the point, basically, you're just telling your brain that, no, this is bad, and then it just accepts it as bad. Because at one point you can, like, for instance, I guess in the article, I think it uses carrots as an example. Like, eating it raw is a no. It tastes awful. It tastes like shit. It's bad. But if you blend it, you could probably drink it, and I'd probably be fine.
Huh. Really?
Yeah.
So is it like, it's like psychological? It's a texture-based psychological
thing?
Yeah,
essentially.
Not necessarily flavor.
But not necessarily in flavor. I mean, flavor can still be a part of it. But that could just be because you hate it, but...
And you can't really identify what sets it off. It's just certain types of textures. You're like bleh, and you... No, you can't. And you...
Yeah. And that mainly goes a lot for me on the whole vegetables and fruits. Mostly vegetables.
You still get certain vegetables, right?
Nope. I've been horrible, so...
Did you get vitamins?
I did, at one point. But then I had, like, a calcium buildup, and then I got kidney stones. That was fun.
Did the vitamins cause that, or...?
It may have been a part or a contribute to it, apparently.
Huh, interesting. Weird. So that sucks.
Yeah.
You should definitely try getting your
fun.
Nutrients, your vital nutrients somehow, if you can eat something.
Yeah, I've been trying to find ways.
Long run, yeah. Well, you said it was texture-based, so you could always try, you know, putting them in, like, a smoothie or something, like, grind them up in a blender and add yogurt.
Yeah, that's one of the ideas, is basically trying to, see if I can blend shit and then just kind of do that whole thing. But I just haven't gotten a blender. I need to go get a blender.
Gotcha.
I need to do it rather sooner than later. So. Fun times.
Well, I think you'd like... it's sushi's questionable. I would probably want to take you to a place where they have other varieties so you can try sushi. And then if you don't like it, you can just be like, alright, I'm getting something. Wings Over Broadway is the bomb. I'm trying to think of other places. What else would you... Has Matt talked to you about it? Like, what would he do? What would...
No. I haven't talked to Matt about it. So.
Oh.
I haven't talked to anyone about it.
Oh, damn.
Other than Jonathan, but...
You told Jonathan?
Yeah, I know. Weird. Weird that.
Would he be visiting too, or nah?
No. That would be a hard fail. There's no way to do it unless I physically drive there.
Oh, gotcha.
And that's just not happening because I can barely drive anyways.
Wait, what do you mean? Are you still having that sleep issue?
Oh, yeah.
Is that why you can't drive, really?
Not long, like long trips.
Jesus, man, that sucks.
It just bores the shit out of me. And, I just get really sleepy real quick.
Jesus Christ. Have they done anything more with that, or are you just kind of like, it is what it is?
It's probably going to be what is, it is what it is. Because the doctor is an ass.
You haven't tried switching?
No, I have to do that time schedule thing still, where I have to basically go to sleep on time.
I forgot about that. Have you not been keeping up on that, or no?
No, I've been on it. I've been doing it.
Okay.
And then I have to wait just till the next visit, and that's where it's going to basically either be like, essentially, either he's going to be like, oh, okay, so it does look like you actually tried to fix your schedule. So we're going to give you so-and-so. But from last meeting, he said that he does not want to prescribe me anything because my sleep schedule is out of whack. But we'll see if he just sticks with that. So.
It might. You never know. I could understand, for being a person who has been, you know, sick with multiple things and have to deal with all that, I have been on a lot of pills before. And I'll be perfectly honest, if you can avoid taking pills, you absolutely should, because they fuck with your body, and I hate it.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
But yeah, if I could also understand where some doctors are just like unwilling. Oh no, 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 no! And you're like, God, please, just fix the problem. Oh no, no.
Like it's nothing's just working, and I need something to do for that way I can keep working. Mainly.
Have you tried putting something in your car you can listen to and like actively pursue, like a book, an audiobook, or even something to sing to purposefully force yourself to sing to? I wouldn't recommend
doing
that.
Well, I'm gonna do that at work, but
yeah, I wouldn't do that across a cross country trip either, because your lungs would go out or your voice would go out. But still, like an audiobook might actually be okay.
But no, to that extent, I have tried that. It does help. A lot, generally. But after a while, my brain just crapped out. And
huh.
I tune it out. And then it becomes white noise in the background. And then that's where it starts to slowly decline. And then I go back to nodding.
You can always try experimenting with your limits with that, and like, okay, so maybe 1 hour of audiobook, and then you like get out of the car and you walk around for a bit or something to like.
Yeah, that's what I'm supposed to do, and it becomes annoying even more because now I'm making the trip two times long. But I mean, if it's half that I have to do it, but. Supposed to go to the box. No.
It must make fucking planes really actually nice to travel on. If you could just get on a plane and then fall
off. Oh yeah, that's fine. I could do that anytime.
That sounds blissful to me, because every time I'm on a plane, I can't sleep. I have to be disgusting.
I think there was one plane where I couldn't do that, but that's mainly because the seats were fucking tiny. And they're so cramped, I just couldn't do anything.
Well, welcome to my world all the time. I'm not even that tall. I'm only 5'11", close to 6 feet tall. 5'11 and 3 quarters.
Oh, yeah, I'm 5'11". So.
Oh, you are? I thought you were shorter than me.
Nope.
Really?
5'11".
What the fuck? I could have sworn that you were closer to Matt's height. Not a little bit taller. Maybe I'm thinking of someone else. Jeez.
Nah, I'm not as short as Matt.
It has been a long time since I fucking seen you. Holy shit. So, but yeah, I'm mostly legs, though. I have very long legs for a relatively short torso. So everywhere I sit, especially planes, it's like, oh my god, my legs are automatically jammed against the seat in front of me. I fucking hate it.
Yeah, yeah, I can see that. Just like about that height, we're almost too tall, but not too short.
I tell you, you probably have more of a normal ratio, like torso to leg ratio, than I do, though.
Probably. I didn't actually look at that.
So. I know it's the case because I'll sit in someone else's chair after driving, like it's my turn to drive or something, and I'll have to push the chair seat way back. Or I've also had other times where I'll be sitting at a table, like a dining table, with other people, and new people come in. This happened at Denny's in Benson. And I was like everyone else's height, you know, sitting there, and then I stood up and they're like, holy shit!
Yeah.
Because I'm mostly fucking legs.
Too much leg.
Excuse me. Well, if you'd be flying down here. But yeah, I guess I'm trying to think of other stuff you can do.
Yeah, I would be flying.
Probably be visiting Matt. Probably be like over Broadway.
2-3 transfers as usual.
You'd probably at least go out one night to drink with Matt. I guarantee that. I don't think you're not a big drinker.
Nah, I'd probably take a drink or two and then be like, all right, well, that's it.
Probably go out. He'd probably get you to go out for at least one round of drinks. Well, that's shit. And I'm trying to think of what else. I mean, it is still Tucson. I like it, but it's not.
Still crazy old Tucson.
Crazy old Tucson. I guess there's movies.
Movies aren't real.
Movies aren't real. You got shit. Now that these things are. I'm talking about this, and here I was thinking just recently, like, oh man, once the quarantine goes away and it's safe and not stupid to go out, I am totally going to go out and do all these things in places. And now that I'm thinking, it's like, I got one or two places. It was like ramen and Wings Over Broadway and sushi and Mexican food. It's all food places. I guess I'm a foodie.
Sounds like it. Sounds like you're a foodie.
So I'm just hungry. Just
dirty, dirty foodie.
Dirty, disgusting foodie. That sounds dangerously close to futa. Yeah, I'm just a futa.
Yeah, I guess you're right there, yeah.
I guess futa. I'm just a woman with breasts with a big old dick. I'm just a futa.
Hyper boobs.
Hyper boobs. You know, it's so weird. I find that one so odd. The whole Fuda fetish. It's not a bad one. I don't find it gross. But it's so interesting because I have legit seen people who are so adverse to anything homosexual, yet they still like Fuda. And it's like, why?
I don't know. I don't get it.
And they're like, yeah, but you put that on a guy's body with no boobs and it's bad. But then you put it with boobs and it's good. It's like, but I don't understand.
I don't understand either one being hyper. I don't know. But there's lots of things that are just weird. So I don't know.
Yeah, I'm not judging them for it.
It's not for me.
I just have a hard time comprehending that one where you could be like, no gay, but
no gay.
Okay. And I'm like, Fuda's why?
Great. Oh god, it has a dick. No. Ruined forever.
Apparently, that's a very popular one. Like, there was this Pornhub survey or whatever that they showed, like, during quarantine lockdown, the most searched phrases in, like, Europe and states in America and China and whatnot.
All right.
The majority were legit Fuda in the United States.
Oh, Jesus.
They went per state, you know. So yeah, it was like you had, you know, you had the incest, you had the Fuda, you had the tentacles, you had,
I figured it would just be tentacle.
Tentacles was... It was there, but it wasn't as big. I think it was mostly Fuda. Huh. Let me look up that list. It was largest searched hentai terms, I think. Not just porn. Most searched hentai terms. Pornhub. Map. Why am I doing this without my glasses? This is really straining my eyeballs.
I don't know if I'm just doing this puzzle wrong, or if I'm just not getting enough momentum.
Most searched hentai terms map.
I wonder if I should do that. Maybe it'll bounce me higher enough.
Nope.
No. No, that did not work. That was a miserable jump. Pretty sure you gotta use speed. It's just not wanting to work, though.
Huh. Oh, here's this map. This is interesting. The detailed map of world's porn interests. This is... female visitors. The number of female visitors to porn sites. And the highest amount is in northern China, like Mongolia area. Apparently women's are really horny up there. And the least is the Middle East. Go figure. Because they are the least horny because of what they have to deal with.
Well, apparently I just wasn't getting enough fucking momentum. Stupid.
Listen. Hey, listen up down there. That thing's called an elevator, not a bathroom.
I swear I know him.
I can't find it now. I can only find the real world terms, you know, like teen and MILF and all that other stuff. I can't find it now. I can't find the hentai terms. It's gonna bother me.
Well, you know, just wear a Fuda helmet.
Here we go. Oh, no, it wasn't by Pornhub. It was by Faku.
Faku.
Because, yeah, I guess that's a... I don't use Faku. I guess it's a paid hentai site or something.
Oh.
But they did something... Right. They did something much like Pornhub, where they're like, during this quarantine, our services are free to stay home.
I don't think Pornhub is free. Well...
They did something.
Oh, no, you're right. Never mind. Yeah, they did.
Okay, most searched terms.
Ah.
Aha! Here we go, found it.
The most popular tags. Oh, damn.
Yeah, look at that!
It's cheating.
Cheating is there. That's in Hawaii. I guess cheating's big there.
Also New Hampshire or Vermont. Whatever one it's.
Yeah, but a lot of it is Futanari. It's like, wow, really?
Yeah, apparently.
Like, is that Utah with harem?
No, that's Colorado.
No, Colorado's anal.
Then it's Wyoming.
Colorado's right next to two.
Utah's to the left of anal.
No, that's New Mexico.
What? No.
No, 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 you're right, you're right. No, wait.
Utah's right above Arizona.
You're right, that's Utah. Utah, Colorado, Arizona, New Mexico's to the right, and that's Nevada to the left. I thought, for some reason, I thought Nevada was directly above Arizona.
That'd be kind of weird.
So that's Utah. Is still Futanari, so... U.S. states. That is, yep, you're right, it's Wyoming.
Okay. Just monster curse.
What is Netto Rare? I don't know that term.
Look it up. Yeah, I don't know, that one's new to me.
Urban Dictionary is a genre of adult manga or hentai. It should be defined as cheating. Well, why do they have cheating down there and Putinari there? What's the difference? Oh, it's
like
it's a certain type.
I was gonna say like a different variant of it or something.
Okay, so this is one. However, true readers of the genre know that this fetish. Watching. Netto Rare, the boyfriend, girlfriend, wife, husband do not have to make an appearance in the story whatsoever. They often do not ever find out about the betrayal.
Huh.
It's just cheating, not cuckolding. So what the fuck is just regular cheating in comparison to Netto Rare?
I don't know.
I don't even understand. It's
people playing poker and they're just cheating. Or it's someone playing checkers and they're cheating. Yeah.
I guess I'll click on the direct article and see if I can find it.
I'm gonna click on this video and find.
Find Futanari.
Okay, did not expect that.
What is the difference between cheating and Netto Rare? Okay, cheating is just someone, usually the girl, cheating on someone else, usually the guy. Netto Rare is the same thing, just with the guy forced to watch. That doesn't... This definition is telling us something else entirely.
Sounds like cuckold, though. Well, not well. Being forced though is different, I guess.
What is cucks enjoy it, right?
Yeah, they just sit off the side.
So maybe this watch. Is forced to watch, but they don't like it. I'll click some other ones. Which not only encompasses cheating but cooking. Okay, girl steals. This one, so unlike Urban Dictionary, it's saying that Netto Rare is cheating, but it's also potentially cucking. Cheat yar? Oh, fuck it. I don't care anymore. I quit. Anyway.
I give up.
There's so many people like, it's this. And then someone down below goes, no, it's this.
Ooh, you can't describe my indiscriminate porn selection as this one. Group.
What thing? Get these subcultures, man. You're insulting the subcultures.
It's an insult to my heritage.
My dad Netto Rared, and his dad Netto Rared.
I know what to do now. I finally figured it out, because I was a dum-dum. A big old dummy.
Ugh, I need to shave. Oh yeah, so you brought up your camera thing, because I said I needed to shave. What, did you have a beard rocking or something?
Yeah, I got a long one. Kind of going.
You got a long one? How long?
Kind of long. Not that long, though. I don't know how to measure it.
I guess the tip of your pinky is roughly an inch. So your pinky to your pinky knuckle, your second knuckle there is
What, from like my chin?
Sure, from your chin. So that's about an inch and a half to your second pinky knuckle, if we have the similar sized hands.
It's longer than my pinky.
Longer than your pinky, okay, so it's longer than an inch and a half. What about your middle finger? Middle finger is probably about two and a half inches.
Alright. About maybe that length.
Okay.
About the length of my middle finger. It was longer, but I had trimmed it down quite a bit. Because it was starting to get in the way. Oh, crap, I spin it. Fuck! Whoops! Fucked up. Oh, that sucks. Put me way back here. Dying is awful. Yeah, so everyone's basically just been doing cameras because they've gone all insane, and everyone just is having more fun with that at the moment than actually playing games.
Oh, really? How many people were in on it?
Zane, Josh, Matt, Beef, Mike didn't have cameras, he was able to, Ben, Handsome Matt. Kevin and Laura.
They've all been FaceTiming?
No, they're just all on camera and Discord.
Yeah, well, that's what I kind of mean by
FaceTiming. Oh, well, yeah, I guess. That way.
I guess not the actual app or program, if that's a thing, but just being on cam talking. I don't have a cam. Damn. I must be really desperate for fucking social interaction. Jesus.
A little bit. A wee bit. That's why I've been taking weird snippets of them in the video chat. And then we make very weird things out of them.
Yeah, that's right. I have seen the pictures of that and you guys doing stuff.
In case you're interested, there's still some positions available for that bonus.
I've almost felt like contributing, because I have not taken a picture of myself, really, except for the one, and I asked for where I'm sticking my tongue out.
Yeah, I haven't done that.
I am the least photogenic person on the planet, though. It's weird, people go, oh, Harper, you're not ugly, and I go, no, I don't think I'm actually that. I'm mildly goofy looking, but in terms of cameras, no, I am terrible.
I don't know. I probably have your beat.
What, in terms of goofy looking?
No. Photos.
I don't know, man. I don't know. It's a hard bet. You have some real competition with there. I really don't think I'm photogenic.
For many of you, I realize $60 is an unprecedented windfall, so don't go spending it all on, I don't know, Carolyn, what do these people buy? Tattered hats? Beard dirt?
right back. Gotta go grab a drink. Okay, back momentarily. Sorry about that. Making myself some tea.
Tea?
Making myself some pee.
Pee?
Making myself some bee.
There's no bees.
Nope, there's only murder wasps now.
Yep, murder hornets all over.
munching chips into the microphone.
Mmm, chips.
Mmm, chili cheese Fritos.
Actually, those are pretty good. They used to make, chili, wheat thins.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Guess they didn't sell very well, because I have never seen them.
Yeah, you know, I'm guessing that, but when they were out, they were really good.
Damn. You know the ones I like are actually not regular Triscuits, but like the flavored ones, like garlic and rosemary, stuff like that. Oh, those are good.
What Jonathan likes. He likes the Triscuits. You like the Triscuits.
Oh, I like Wheat Thins.
He likes
too,
the Triscuits.
Wheat Thins are all
mainly the Triscuits. Wheat Thins are
like
mine.
Wheat
he likes them.
I like both.
I don't care for Triscuits.
I just don't like plain Triscuits. Plain Triscuits are like dry and
I just haven't found one that I like. I don't like any of the tastes. I don't like them. I don't know. But Wheat Thins are fun. I can eat those plain.
So, what about burger places down here if you visited? Do you like, you've probably been to an In-N-Out, which is okay. I like Five Guys, to be honest.
I mainly get my burgers plain, or with ketchup and mayo.
I think you'd like Five Guys. Big old juicy, greasy burger with cheese.
I think I've had In-N-Outs. They kind of remind me of like Burger King or Carl's Jr. almost-ish.
Hmm.
I know they're nice and big, but Big Burgers or Five Guys, I haven't actually been to one yet. I know there's one here.
Oh, really? You should try it sometime. Just ask for a regular cheeseburger or bacon, I guess, but they're huge and they're greasy and they're delicious.
Greasy-licious.
They are greasy. That's why I like them. They're huge, greasy burgers. Oh. All right, my tea's done. Quick BRB. Hey, guys.
Hey, man. How's it going?
Shitty.
Just waking up? I mean, sleeping or overdosing? I mean, you know.
Kinda. I took a nap earlier and ended up falling asleep, and now my. I feel like crap.
Yeah, alright. I gotcha. I hate when that happens. That's never any fun. They just feel off. All day.
Pretty much. Anyway, how y'all doing?
Alright, I'm replaying Portal 2 because I don't think I've actually ever played through the entire thing except one time, and I don't remember much about it. So I decided to do that. And then Harper's making tea?
Tea is good.
I think
Jacksepticeye did a playthrough of the game on his channel recently, so when I saw he did it, I played through Portal 2.
Yeah.
Really good game. I still think it feels way too short.
I'm about 3 hours in, which is much longer than the first Portal game, so.
Yeah. Where are you?
I'm still in Cave Johnson's area, 1982.
Okay.
Right now, I'm kind of stuck. I actually don't know what I'm supposed to do, because I don't remember where to go.
Do the thing.
I would. I would totally do the thing. But I'm missing something obvious, so... No. Supposed to go here, I think. But the door's closed. It's blocked off, so I can't go in there. Or that's where I came from. Maybe. I don't know.
Hello. Hello.
Aaron's here now. He's
oh
half alive.
Half alive.
like Half-Life, the game.
You just waking up, or?
Woo.
Kinda, yeah. I took a nap and ended up falling asleep. Fuck. Well, did you want to play Trine, or?
No, I'm in no mood at the moment.
Well, did you want to play Trine?
Not, well, like, yes, but no. Thing is, I have to go back to bed in a few hours. I really hope I can fall asleep.
Really? Shitty. You don't get help with that.
Sex? When do you want to have sex with me?
I mean, if we could have sex and then play Trine at the same time.
Yeah. I mean, technically, if all three of us were in there, that'd be a Trine.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. Which is just a giant pile. Call it a Trine pile.
Yeah, call it a
Trine pile.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
So what are you up to then?
Talking to y'all.
Oh, that's
living
not
out the dream.
I was trying to think of stuff to do down here, Aaron, if Lonnie were to visit. I couldn't think of many. It's like the few ones I'm like, I'm super pumped by. But it's like Wings Over Broadway and maybe sushi ramen or burger.
Dude, I don't know what to do. I'm a super boring person when I'm away from my computer.
Yep, I missed the obvious. That was really dumb. I was there for like 15 minutes or something so stupid.
For all employees, the quality of our test subjects has risen dramatically. Employee retention, however, has
But yeah, so far I got Wings on Broadway. Then Wings on Broadway.
Five Guys.
Then Wings on Broadway. Then Five Guys. And then more Wings on Broadway.
Aaron at least has been to Wings on Broadway. It is fucking delicious.
It really is.
Still, it turns out they're a great portal conductor. So now, we're going to see if jumping in and out of these new portals can somehow
what else is down here that you've had that you liked, Aaron? Took some.
Oh, I like all sorts of food.
You haven't had anything that really struck out, though? I guess one thing you could do, Lonnie, is easily, because you just mentioned you don't really have access to good Mexican food in Maine, is go out and get some good fucking Mexican food.
Good.
Oh, Chile Colorado? Oh, so good.
Colorado.
Chile Colorado.
And we're at the white paint fucking factory.
Oh boy.
What? Paint everywhere! Paint everywhere! Paint everywhere! Rah, rah, rah.
Yeah,
Wheatley. Wheatley.
Cool it, cool it, cool it, cool it.
God damn it.
It's probably porn.
Probably porn.
It's always porn with me, really.
It's so sad. I'm not even making this up. Since I had to deal with that stuff regularly, somewhat regularly, drawing and all that, there are some things that have been posted in pure filth that I'm like, I just got done doing work. I don't want to deal with this. Some of the stuff in the pure filth channel.
Yeah, I get desensitized to that crap. Is it? Yeah, that's another one. What of it?
It does lose its shock value. I'll definitely give it that. But no, it's just like, I already did this in work. I don't want to deal with this right now.
Well, yeah. You can also just ignore it.
What?
Watch out.
Oh, no. Because every once in a while, there's something really gross in there. Yeah, you're right. I could ignore it. Like the lady popping eyeballs in. Oh, so creepy. So creepy.
Yeah, that was pretty gross.
Oh, man. Multiple power blackouts caused by man trying to relaunch Hentai Haven by himself. Wow.
Wait, what?
I guess that's the thing that happened. Fox News reported this on this. So it's Fox News, but Chuck's on Handsome Matt linked it in Pure Filth.
Ah.
Multiple power blackouts caused by man trying to relaunch Hentai Haven by himself.
Huh.
Yeah, it's, I remember when that closed, and all the circles that I was in Discord, is that every once in a while it would pop up. And I just, like, okay, and I just dismissed it because I never used Hentai Haven. I don't get what it was.
I'd never even heard of it.
Yeah. I'm guessing it's pretty much just like a Pornhub for hentai. And it's like, well, why? Because you could just go to Pornhub and search hentai. I don't understand.
Because you can.
Because
why not? Why not have at least 10 million different sites that do the same thing?
Yeah, that was the that was the special place to do it.
It's only special because you get to actually log in. Make an avatar of your shit character that actually participates into the porn. So it's like VR, but not.
That's
just
like that one. There's a site that people are using, and I've heard about it so much because artists complain about it. We'll have their characters just taken and used for that. So F-list. There we go. F-list.
List?
Yeah.
What is it now?
I guess it's a role-playing board. You can use it for anything. I never would never go there. Just like I have no interest. It's like no. But yeah, apparently a lot of people who do the whole role-playing thing go there and they'll yoink other people's artwork illegally and claim it as their own and just use it and role-play as that character. And
oh.
So many artists I know get pissed about that.
Yeah, I would too, if someone claiming your work is theirs.
I don't think they're claiming the work is theirs. They're just role-playing as the character.
Oh.
Well, some people don't want to use their character in that manner.
Yeah.
Is basically what you're trying to do.
Well, yeah, I'm sure a lot of people don't, but oh well, that's the fucking internet.
Yeah, I don't really get why people get pissy with that one. I can understand, like... It's not a cool thing to do, but it's not a huge thing.
Well, I mean that's the basis for Rule 34.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's not like all these artists have drawn some of that before, because I know I have. No, I just... If they're not earning money off of it, then I don't care. It's
yeah.
Like, I'm not going to be thrilled by it, sure, but I don't... It's not going to bother me. Like, not going to ruin my day. Yeah, it's a whatever.
It's just one of those things.
So F-List is formatted as a list-based database of characters and personas. Each member can register blah 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 and assign kinks and values to each kink that they want, so you could choose and interact with them there. Upon creating a character, a user is given an expansive list of kinks. Yeah, it's just a role-playing board.
Okay.
So they're not even selling it. I don't know why that popped into my head. I can't even remember how we got there now. Anyway, there was something I was thinking of, and I can't remember what it was about. God damn it, Aaron.
Yep, I am damned. Going to hell.
It was game related. It was something. It wasn't Trine. When does, oh yeah, when are you taking off for your road trip?
Not until late next week.
Okay.
Let me see here real quick. So, Thursday of next week. So, a week from Thursday.
Okay. Should get bits of time.
I don't know how long Trine 4 is.
17 hours.
Daytime. 10 and 15 hours. That's actually pretty good. That's a pretty good chunk of time for a multiplayer game like that.
Yeah.
I think we beat the first two in like, what, maybe 3 to 4, maybe 5?
Yeah, it's saying about 9 hours on average. No.
9 hours? PC, this one says, this list says 6 hours.
For the main story, so I don't know.
Trine 2, yeah, you're right. Trine 2 has close to 9 hours. Trine 3 is a joke. Trine 4. Yeah, Trine 4 is the longest so far. 10 to 15 hours.
Well. It's all that hentai porn.
All the hentai porn.
Really helped again.
Batman does not kill.
Well, unless it's modern day WB Batman, then he kills. I've actually never seen those Batman movies with Ben Affleck.
What, the nipple Batman?
The
nipple Batman?
No, the recent ones.
Nipple Batman.
Batman v Superman was Batfleck, and then he had like a guest appearance in Suicide Squad. Oof.
I've never seen that either. I've heard they're all terrible.
I hated Batman v Superman. Which is weird because I actually think Man of Steel, the Superman, the movie that came before it, was underrated. I enjoyed that one. But yeah, I think Batman v Superman was a goddamn mess.
I never watched them.
I went to... my mom, my brother, and I all went to see Batman v Superman in the theater, and it was for my brother's birthday. And I was angry with my brother because I couldn't walk out of the movie since it was his birthday movie. I didn't, like, yell at him or anything. I was, like, stewing and resenting him. It's like, we had to see this for your fucking birthday. We had to do this. No, we couldn't do something else. It was 3 hours of pain I was forced to endure.
Oof. Ouch.
Yep. No, the Nipple Batman movies, I kind of like, actually.
Yeah, Nipple Batman is the
I like because they're cheesy.
They are super cheesy. Yeah,
third and fourth. That's the you know, it's weird because everyone took them so seriously at the time. But in retrospect, I was able to watch them, like, understanding what they were. And it's like, these movies aren't trying to be serious at all. They're trying to be camp as fuck.
Yeah. But that's the thing, is they came also right after the Tim Burton's Batmans, which were still kind of campy, but really fun, you know?
Tim Burton turned down the role? It wasn't that they decided to recast. Not Tim Burton, Michael Keaton.
Yeah.
Yeah. He was like, fuck this script.
Yeah, you know, it's weird. I still think he probably made the right choice. Those movies... they're not, I wouldn't call them good, but they are really good, crappy B-movie schlock. They're really entertaining for being bad.
Oh, yeah. I wouldn't even call Batman and Robin, okay, Batman and Robin's pretty bad, yeah, that's true. I just think it's so, it knows it wants, it doesn't want to be bad, anything but bad. It's weird, it's like, I look at this movie and it's like, this movie is exactly what it wanted to be.
It does feel like that. Both of those. I do think that they embrace the corniness a bit more with the fourth one with Arnold.
Yeah. Oh my god, yes.
I need you. Stay cool. Stay cool.
Get as much ice jokes or puns in there as you can.
And what killed the dinosaur?
The ice dinosaur!
Freeze, bird boy.
So many.
Kick some ice.
And they just have wacky Jim Carrey. So.
No, the moment of ultimate camp, when it's just like, this is just amazing that they actually did this, is when they're having the auction for like the dates, and Poison Ivy shows up, and Batman and Robin are there, and she like does the whole thermal dust thing to like make them fall in love with her, and they're like trying to outbid her, and then Batman whips out the Bat credit card.
Ching!
It's like, wow.
Of course, Bat credit card.
Oh, that makes sense, right?
Yeah. Don't leave home without your Bat credit card.
Man.
I need to rewatch those sometime. It'll be bad, but it'll be good. Primarily the one with Arnie. I think the one with Jim Carrey. It's entertaining, but it's on that cusp of like, were they doing it seriously or were they trying to be really campy with it? And it's like it doesn't do both. Or sorry, it tries to do both, which means it's
right.
Kind of lacking in each.
When I actually did a marathon with my brother-in-law of these a few years back. We watched like all the Batman movies in a row.
Mm-hmm.
My impression of the third one, Batman Forever, was that it was boring. It just kind of didn't know what it wanted to be and just sort of did everything kind of like halfway.
Yeah.
Whereas Batman and Robin really leaned into the camp and understood what it wanted to be, so it didn't give a shit. And that made it fun.
I need to rewatch the first two especially. Like, I've seen the one with Jack Nicholson quite a few times. I don't think I have seen the one with Danny DeVito as Penguin in 15 plus years, probably more.
When life gives you lemons, don't make
lemons.
That
also had Christopher Walken in it.
Take the lemons back. Get mad. I don't want your damn lemons. What am I supposed to do with
this?
Yeah, he's the poofy white haired business owner who got Penguin to be the mayor of the city.
Yep.
And also tried to kill what's her face, which ended up making Catwoman somehow. I don't know how that one works, but it's.
So, yeah, so he threw her out of a building.
Yeah.
And then her corpse started getting chewed up by cats.
I thought
and
it was
that turned into Catwoman.
Yeah.
Why can't we store a man's intelligence?
It was very odd. It was interesting.
So I have the engineers figuring that out now. Brain mapping, artificial intelligence. We should have been working on it 30 years ago. I will say this, and I'm going to say it on tape so everybody hears it 100 times a day. If I die before you people can pour me into a computer, I want Carolyn to run this place. Now, she'll argue. She'll say she can't.
Excuse me.
She's modest like that, but you make her. Hell, put her in my computer. I don't care. Test over.
Personally, that's kind of how I view movies as a failure is if it's boring. It's not like the worst thing a movie can be. But generally, when I think of a movie as bad, that's usually what I'm thinking of.
My indicator is if I can walk out of a movie and not remember the characters' names, like at all. That happened with me with Frozen. And I don't want to
remember.
Yeah,
you do not want a bad mouth Frozen around me. Just saying.
Okay, I'll just leave it as I did not like it.
Fair enough.
I thought it was alright.
I'm trying to think if there was a movie that had happened with me.
That's like the greatest.
I could remember the character names.
It was mostly the bulk of the movie. Like the one famous song, Let It Go, was actually a good scene. Don't get me wrong on that one. That was good, but it's the story. Yeah, I won't get into it though. A movie like that was like that for you, where you didn't remember, like, you're like, huh?
Yeah.
I don't know. Well, what's a recent movie that you hated that we might have liked, or I might have liked instead?
I don't really... Oh, well, there was Joker.
Oh, I haven't. I've yet to
see. I didn't see Joker. So.
I don't know if that movie was like. I don't know. I don't know about that movie. I know I did not like it, and that I going back, I would not like it again. It's not one of those I didn't get it the first time around, because, I mean, I've ruminated on it since then. I understand like the, you know, the subtleties of the movie. I just didn't like it. I don't know that I can say it's a bad movie. I do think it's a problematic movie.
I heard, after I heard that it was just pretty much a different version of Taxi, that I was, or was it Taxi Driver with Robert De Niro, the good movie? Then I was like, oh, it's that type. And I just kind of lost interest because I was like, I don't want another movie like that. It was a good, Taxi's a great movie, but I don't fucking want another movie like that.
Here's the thing. It's like, the movie almost wants you to sympathize with the character, Joker's character, but he's a piece of shit. So I can't. As opposed to Taxi Driver, where you are clearly not supposed to like this guy. He's clearly a psycho. And I can't tell if Joker is just a bad movie that doesn't understand, like that you're supposed to hate this character, and it just failed to do that, or if it's just it's just a different kind of movie, and how can I put this? I'm trying to give the movie credit. I don't know if it deserves that credit, but I am trying to give it to it.
Gotcha.
If that makes any sense. Let me think of a movie. Okay, what's the last movie I saw that I'm just prepared to definitively declare bad? Oh, I don't know if y'all have ever watched Hail Caesar. That's on Netflix.
Nope.
That one I very much enjoyed. I just watched it the other day. It's a weird movie that took forever for me to understand what it's about. But it's basically about capitalism, and it uses the old Hollywood system basically as that as kind of the stand-in. But it's got like lots of weird themes, like the idea of Hollywood as Christianity and all sorts of shit. It's very strange, but I very much enjoyed the movie. Oh, come on.
I need to catch up on, like, Netflix and stuff like that. Like, I need to get, honestly, the demo, or what are the free trial version of Disney Plus so I could finish The Mandalorian. I got halfway through, I think. I need to finish
it. I did finish that.
Let me see. Oh, I know what I saw that was bad. Cats.
I didn't see that either.
I have heard that is not even B-movie good. I've heard people who were hoping it would be bad walked out angry because it's that kind of bad.
It's just plain bad. But it's sucks. You know, I enjoyed it for what it was at the time. You know, where it's like once it got halfway through the movie and it stopped being as weird as it could be and it was just sort of an operatic ballet, it's like, it's fine. I'm enjoying what it is. Then I watched the actual stage play, and I went, oh, wow, the movie sucked.
Nice.
Holy crap, it screwed up everything. it's the kind of movie I think if I went back and watched it now, I'd go, yeah, I don't know why I liked this. This movie sucked.
Yeah, I just heard that it was bad.
That's actually one of the reasons why I have not watched the latest Batman movies, is because I really like Batman. Like, I grew up with Batman and his comics, and it's just like, I'd rather preserve my liking of Batman. The last one I watched was the one with Bane. I can't remember what the title of the movie was, but
Dark Knight Rises.
Yeah, despite that movie getting a lot of flack, I still had fun with it.
Oh, I think that movie's actually good. Legitimate, not just enjoyable, good.
I don't think it's anywhere near the one with Joker, with Heath Ledger as the Joker.
Dark Knight.
That movie is fucking amazing. It's one of my favorites. But it was still good, the one with Bane. I liked it. I do not get why people disliked it so much.
Oh, with Bane?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I don't see many movies every year, and I'm looking through the list of theatrical releases, and it's like there's It Chapter 2, which wasn't as good as Chapter 1.
Didn't watch those either.
Yeah, I just generally don't do horror movies. Not my thing.
Yeah, generally.
Oh, so I saw this when it came out in video, The Lion King, quote-unquote, live action.
I did watch that.
That movie was pointless and shouldn't exist.
I hated it.
I heard it was very dull, and then one of the critics said one of the most obvious things was, like, they just lacked emotion and expression. And it's like, well,
very
no
much.
Well, you know, the thing is, they have, yeah, they went, like, as realistic as possible, and it means that their faces just sort of speak, but they never emote.
Yep.
So
yep.
You have these dead characters, which was, from the moment I saw the first trailer, was what I said is going to be the problem.
Yep.
And the thing is, it affected their voices, because they had to keep their voices in check because their faces couldn't match. So their vocal performances are dull. I got to the part where Mufasa dies, and... The thing is, it's a shot-for-shot remake, but because it lacks the stylization of the original, it looks so bad and lacks any impact.
It didn't look anything like it was in the cartoon, and it made it look
very
impactful, so it made, like, his death not... I don't know, it just didn't... Like, it didn't matter at all.
It didn't emote. It was dull, and they didn't emote.
Well, it's not even just, like, his expression. It was the actual animation of... him coming out in the clouds or the stars or whatever, that portion, like, it was just a jacked up view. It just sucked.
Yep. Yeah, I watched basically through the death of Mufasa, and that was it. When Simba, like, screams, no, and they do a pull away, it looked like he was just meowing because there's no emotion in his face. So it looks like he's just, like doing anything else. It was terrible.
Yeah, I watched all of it. It didn't get any better.
I guarantee you that the problem came from the execs, because what's his face? The guy, he's done a ton of stuff. I can't think of what his name is. The guy, the director of it. I guarantee he knew what the problems were. But I'm sure the exec said, nope, we want this to be live action. No,
we want money.
I mean, that's kind of what they're doing with every... original classic, anyways.
Well, that I actually saw something recently, a couple months ago, the live action Aladdin movie, which I haven't seen.
I did watch that one. Actually, thought it was all right.
I did not really much care for it.
There was parts in it, don't get me wrong, that were not classic, and I think for what he did to try and pull off as the genie, I think he did fine.
Oh, you know, that's actually a weird thing. I was talking to someone else about that. We actually liked, well, go figure, we liked Will Smith in it. We think Will Smith did a good job. My actually big beef with it was the other main actors, the guy who plays Aladdin, especially him, and to a certain degree, Jasmine.
Yeah, I can see that, especially Jasmine.
Just did not do a good job acting, I felt. I just felt that they were...
They felt very disconnected at times, and it was kind of weird, but...
I just didn't like the characters. Like, not even on an acting level, just on a, like, I don't really... There's nothing here that's making me go, ooh, and ah. It's just, these people are here, they're on screen, they are taking up time.
Pretty much. It's also kind of the same thing with Jafar. It was like, well, he's...
I hated Jafar. Oh my god. I did not like him at all.
I think...
Just like power.
Well, he was just a dude with a beard. I did like...
He didn't look like anything like Jafar.
Enough. Well, they didn't go far enough with the idea that I think really could have set the movie apart and made it a movie worth seeing as opposed to the animated one, is the idea of Jafar as the dark mirror of Aladdin. This is what Aladdin could be if things went down a different road. They tried to go with that theme, like when he had him talk about he used to be a thief.
They said it once.
Yeah, it's a good scene. I like how they're even sitting next to each other, but they're, like, facing opposite directions. Little things like that help to push the theme together. And it's like, okay, this is an interesting direction. I'm curious where they're going with this. You know, that Jafar could be the dark version of Aladdin. And then they never did it again. It's a theme that barely had any weight. It's like, okay. That's fine. You just keep going on with making the same movie, but changing nothing, but also lacking everything that made the real version good.
It's just what they do. They kill it all.
But yes, I did very much enjoy Will Smith as the genie.
Yeah, I thought I actually did.
Particularly when
pretty
he
good.
Was able to be Will Smith.
Yeah, pretty much.
He's just so fucking charming.
That's one thing about him. I wish he could be in a good movie again, like a whole
right.
good movie. I missed him around, but the shit he's been in has all been bad. The last movie I saw that I genuinely liked with him in it was the third Men in Black movie. I actually liked that one. I thought that was pretty good.
Oh, I did too. I laughed my ass off.
Yeah, that's the last one I can think that I actually liked.
Yeah, that was the last one.
Then, I think the one after that, though, I watched that. What is it? Blink or Dust or whatever is it? Weird troll goblin alien.
Oh
movie.
Yeah, that Netflix thing.
Oh yeah, I heard that was good. I never saw that one.
No.
I never heard anything but that it was trash.
Oh really? The
yeah.
Netflix special where he's a fantasy cop?
Yeah. It was slow. Very slow. They didn't really push anything towards the story. Didn't really help. It's like they were trying to do the whole preparing to get out a series instead of actually focusing on doing the movie. So it didn't really...
All world building.
Yeah.
But I heard the world building was crap, so...
Yeah, that didn't help either, because it was crap.
I saw Toy Story 4 last year.
I need to see
that. I still need to watch that one.
It's pretty good. I mean, 3 had such a perfect ending for that story.
Yeah, and they have to go ruin it.
I've already heard the ending for 4. I haven't seen it, but I know the ending, and it's like, I kind of wish they had just left it at 3.
Well, that's the thing. It's the same fucking ending, basically. But it is an enjoyable watch. I did enjoy it.
You enjoyed it?
I enjoyed it.
You Jewed it?
Jewed it up. It's a good thing.
Who was that you recently who said that people weren't considering Jews whites?
Yes, that was me.
Yeah,
what's
that about?
Jonathan was, what was it, tweeting something on Twitter. Trying to think of what it was.
And someone commented that Jews weren't in white category.
Can't remember the exact thing. But he was essentially trying to say, like, you know, with the Jewish history and non-practice, not following it, but still having that background heritage, that people are just being, I think it was rather dismissive or just judgmental in that manner towards other people, because he was trying to talk up on a video he watched earlier. About where police are just being too violent with black people.
Mm-hmm.
And then...
Essentially,
just someone on... A bunch of people, actually. Not even just one person. A bunch of people just said that you can't be white to be Jew. So...
This automatically sounds like they are white supremacists because they were taking part in this conversation.
Yeah.
Which also kind of goes hand-in-hand with they were an anti-Semite as well. So it sounds like he was a real piece of shit.
Yeah.
How the hell would anyone go, oh, Jewish, not white? It's like, beg pardon?
I don't know.
At least in the U.S.
But
this is
one good way of blocking out people very fast, so...
I could understand purely from a color skin perspective. If you went to the Middle East and someone was Jewish, chances are that they might actually look more... Arabic in descent. Chances are, I've never been. This is a guesstimate on mine, so I have no idea.
Same concept that, you know, America is not really founded on anyone's heritage. So.
Yeah.
Excuse me. Let's see. Oh, that's right. I also saw Shazam, which was fun.
I didn't watch that one yet.
That was a very enjoyable movie. I saw Dumbo, which was not.
We're still probably going to watch that one.
That's another pointless movie.
Yeah, I figure as much.
I will give this, at least they tried to do something different with it. It's not just a carbon copy of the original.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, So I will give them that credit, and I did enjoy some of it, but yeah, it's kind of a pointless movie.
I mean, I really didn't care for the original anyways, so that's why I'm not really looking forward to it, but Jonathan wants to watch it, so watch it.
The one that I want to rewatch is actually the original Iron Man, because apparently people loved that movie, and I remember just being like, it's okay.
Is that where he goes? Well, I mean, it's origin story. So everyone likes an origin story.
I just, it's so weird. Almost all of the Avengers movies on their own, I'm just like, it's okay. I'm neutral on to, like, it was mildly fun. Except for Thor Ragnaros. That one's actually good.
Yeah, I don't know.
Which is weird because the prior two Thor movies were bad.
Well, yeah, for Thor, he had a rough break in those last two. But,
yeah.
He did pick up in the Ragnarok, so.
Ragnarok was great. It's weird. Like, the Iron Man's origin movie, I should rewatch it because people love it, and I just, like, it's okay.
I enjoyed it a lot at the time, but I can't honestly tell you whether or not I think it's a good movie. It's been so long.
I mostly just find myself liking most of the Avengers movies. All of them except the second one, I think, are great. And also Guardians of the Galaxy is my favorite out of all.
Yeah, I like those.
Guardians of the Galaxy is,
I love. Well, yeah. I think Guardians of the Galaxy 2 is my favorite MCU movie.
I like the Guardians.
Really, I think I prefer the first one to the second, but I still like the second.
The second one, it's. How can I put this? I love. I don't know. I love the emotion in that movie. It's so damn well done. It to the point where it's like I tear up literally every single time I watch it. I want to cry.
When
it gets towards the end.
Okay.
Oh man. And now I need to go to the bathroom. I'll be right back.
I don't know about you, Vellani, but the talk of sad topics also makes me want to poop viciously.
Oh yeah. I'm already pooping right now. I'm just stuck on this fucking place because I don't remember how to get up.
Have you tried tucking your foot into your butt and then pushing yourself upwards?
That's just how I poop.
Oh.
Wait, where did I get the blue gel? Where I got the blue gel.
Hair salon. Probably the hair salon.
Oh. Fancy.
It's that jar full of blue. It's that jar full of blue liquid that they put the combs in. There you go. It's the magic blue gel.
Magic blue gel.
Oh. You know what's weird? I don't really see hair salons with combs sitting in the blue tonic anymore. I wonder if that's gone the way of the dodo. Something else.
I would say so. Yeah. Oh, is that it?
I would actually hope so, because good lord, I never want to experience lice because of you.
Well, yeah, you don't want that. And everyone's pretty much a bitch and whiner anyways about that stuff, so. Especially now.
Have you ever had lice or nah?
I think I did. Fifth, fourth grade?
Well, that sucks. I have never had it before, so.
Had it once, because I think my sister had it and she brought it home, and then I just got everywhere.
Did you shave your head, or did they actually make you?
No, they just put stuff in my head, like washed it constantly.
I didn't
go the shave route. So.
I honestly think I might shave, because I have such an aversion to parasites that I would be like, nope, I want them gone now. I'm going bald.
My only issue, like, I didn't care about lice at the time, because I don't know, I just didn't care.
You're a kid.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just doing what I had to do, walk around, be dumb. But when bed bugs came, that was a fucking nightmare, so.
You had bed bugs? Oof, Jesus Christ, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, in Utah, awful. We had bed bugs.
Oof.
My great-grandpa an apartment to himself, and he apparently was just constantly saying he was getting bitten. They're like, okay, we'll have to check it out. And someone finally got around to it, and then, yeah, his house was just littered with fucking bed bugs.
Blech.
They were just everywhere, like under the couch, under the furniture, the seats, the chairs, the bed, clothes. They were everywhere. So they literally had to take everything and burn it.
Yep.
And destroy. And yeah, including him himself. And then, but it still ended up getting like a few within, like, my dad that was helping him at the time and brought them over to our place. So then we had to deal with that for a while, and then you could literally just see them crawling out at night.
Blech.
That's because they only come out at night. Yeah, it was fun. Essentially, that's probably where I got most of my insomnia from, probably, at the time.
Damn, dude.
I was like, I'm just gonna stay up. And if I see any that come out, I'm gonna fucking kill it. I'm gonna fucking just kill the fuck out of it.
Yeesh, 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 yeesh.
Yeah, that's how that happened.
I'm thankful I've never experienced anything like that. I get the heebie-jeebies even thinking about shit like that. I have such an aversion to parasites. Anything like ticks, fleas, lice, whatever. Ugh.
Yeah, I'll have that same problem generally with flying bugs. Generally.
Just any flying bugs or house flies? Because house flies are gross.
Nah, those are fine. Anything that typically has the fear to sting or bite me.
Ah. Well, you should actually be worried about house flies. Those are essential. Those are actually been proven to be sometimes germier than cockroaches. They are flying, germy cockroaches.
Yeah, but I can kill those.
Oh, that's true. Oh, with I see what you mean. Kill those. But anything that can sting or fight back, kill it, but only if it is not able to sting you in return.
Yeah. I don't know if I'm allergic. Don't want to find out.
I haven't either. It's not fun getting stung. I've been stung by a bee before.
I have not.
I feel empty.
You would?
Inside?
Yes.
I mean, Harper usually doesn't satisfy you. Anyone.
No. It's like throwing a hot dog down a hallway.
And
it's not, I'm not sure if it's because of my tiny penis or his cavernous butthole. It could be both.
It's both. But I mean, usually I can feel something. Now, it's not like even a, you know, just a wind blowing.
Ugh, God, I keep scratching my face. I need a shave. How the hell did Matt and those guys grow these beards?
I don't know, man.
Oh, they're so irritating.
I don't know. Mine's just not itchy.
I have never gotten past the itchy point because my hair is like steel wool.
I don't know. Mine's never itchy. It's just there. And then I just forget about it sometimes and it just kind of grows out. And I'm like, oh yeah, I have a spirit that gets in my soup. Fuck.
Yeah, I can see that. Fucking.
Wow.
I've always wanted to try to grow out, like, a bigger beard. I just can't. I can't get that path point. Because the hair literally curls back in itself and starts stabbing me in the face. It's just constant irritation and itchy and burningness.
Something's not right here. I'm missing something.
Interesting.
I think the blue fucking thing disappeared on me. It's just not here anymore. Yeah, it just stopped working. No wonder why I couldn't fucking do anything.
interesting. What's up? So when the FCC repealed net neutrality, it did so using the justification of a lot of comments that it had received in favor of repealing. Except it turned out that some of those people who commented were dead.
Oh yeah, no, that's not new news.
Yeah, what is new is that the FCC has been ordered to hand over the IP addresses.
Aha.
By a court. They were ordered to, they repealed, and it's been denied.
Good. Huh.
So
good. Because I think they got caught. A lot of those sayings are things that they were stealing other people's accounts. They were using accounts that people were dead. You know, their social security number. Most people with any kind of brain in their head knew it was bad, and they did not want the repeal. It was big business. They abused the shit out of the system. And Ajit Pai, or whatever the fuck his name is, needs to be fucking put 6 feet under, because he's a real piece of shit. All of those freaking Donald Trump goonies. Shouldn't get into it. I get real pissed with that shit these days. Those guys are assholes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Quick BRB.
Yep. Man, pooping just makes you feel so much fresher and cleaner, you know?
Sometimes. Boing-a-boing.
My leg hurts.
That's good.
I just probably had it in a weird position. Alright, I forget to go to the gold saucer, you know? Actually, I think I might be awake enough to do some trying now, if y'all want to.
I'll leave that to you. I mean, I'm down.
Yeah. Let's see what Harper wants to do when he gets back. I thought I would end up only getting on here saying hi and then going, I'm going back to bed, but now I'm kind of wide awake.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Good thing. Or maybe bad, it depends. Oh, cool, I won the jackpot. Yay.
Thanks to you either way.
Wow, I won the jackpot twice? No, that wasn't jackpot, never mind.
Nope, that's just my heart.
That's 17. Oh, that's jack shit. Screw that. I did win the jackpot twice. Ha!
Jesus.
Awesome.
Mr. Fancy Pants.
I know, right?
What?
Nah, you, just messing around in FF14, and, I won the jackpot in this thing, in the, Golden Saucer. I am actually awake enough if you want to try trying four.
Okay. Sure. I'm down.
Let me just buy some more cackpot tickets. Oh, holy shit, I won? That never happens.
Not surprised. Fucking sold out to them.
Yeah, selling out is what I do.
You do best.
Well, it's fun.
Let me know when you guys want to hop over to Trine. I don't know if you're in the middle of something, Lonnie.
Yeah, I'm just trying to see if I can get to a checkpoint at least. After I figure out.
Checkpoint in that game?
Yeah.
Okay. I thought each level was like its own checkpoint.
I mean, essentially, yeah. That's what I mean. If as soon as I beat this level, I can.
Okay.
Gotcha.
I hate that I love soda so much.
Yeah, me too. But I finally had to stop drinking it. That shit is like smoking. It's terrible for
you. It really is.
I can't help it though. I like it.
Go ahead.
I was just gonna say, you know, it's like you get the drink in you and the burn of it when it's like cold and it's fresh and oh my god, it's like fucking crack.
Delicious crack.
Yep. I had to stop drinking it though because it was actually affecting my body. It was causing me stomach pains.
Oh
shit.
In a way, I kind of wish it would do that for me because that would mean that I actually have a like incentive to end it.
You know, you say that, but because my body, as I've gotten older, is so damn sensitive to everything, like, I just commonly get these problems and medicines and everything else, so it's not a boon, it's a curse.
Yeah, I don't want that.
Yeah, don't be a Harper.
No.
It's the prime example, all those charts that come out.
I will probably eventually be forced to be like, alright, you're having salad for the rest of your life.
Yeah.
Vegetables and salad and maybe an occasional fruit.
I finally had to give up spicy foods.
Oh, that sucks. I still eat spicy foods.
Yeah, it causes too many problems. And I have GERD. I don't know if you know what that is.
Yeah, I have GERD.
Yeah.
Reflux disease.
Yeah, my heartburn and my problems at night are so bad. It's like I can't do anything spicy anymore.
Oh, that sucks.
And oh my, but I mean, I love jalapenos and hot sauce. And I mean, like, quesadillas and tacos and whatnot, they're just not the same.
Nope.
Without spicy foods. Without, like, hot sauce and jalapenos and whatnot. They're just not nearly as good. Poor white me. My intolerance to spices.
So far, if I eat certain spicy foods, I'll have, like, stomach problems. That's about it.
Getting old sucks.
Yeah.
How old are y'all, out of curiosity?
33.
Something like that.
Bonnie's, what are you, 32 or 31?
I think I'm 31.
You think
you're 31? I keep track anymore.
I don't know.
I don't care.
Whatever.
I'm pretty sure it's 31.
No, the only reason I know mine as fast as I did is because it came up recently, but when it did come up, I was the same thing where I was like, I don't know, what am I?
I don't know, something, I don't know.
I will be 39 in, like, 2 months.
Do I still have to keep track of that shit? Why?
About the only thing that kills my gut, well, no, several things kill my gut, but in terms of spicy foods, I am very lucky and thankful that so far it is only combinations of things. So if I have spice and grease, it can be bad, and a good one is chorizo. Chorizo kills my stomach.
Yeah, I can tell.
Are those combinations that turn into Joker gas? And then
yes.
That makes you just die smiling?
Uh-huh.
Love that Joker.
Because I like the spicy chicken. Is that like Burger King? And, if I eat too much of that kind of, like, processed spice bullshit.
Oh, processed spice? Yeah.
That'll destroy me.
Pepper's not a problem yet, thankfully. I had pepper with eggs this morning.
I like the real spicy foods, though. I like habaneros and
Yes. Yum. Well, I'm in game. Whenever y'all are ready.
Alright, I'm pretty sure I'm at least at a point where I can save decently.
Well, you can save anywhere.
It wasn't letting me, actually, for whatever reason. So,
really? That's weird.
I don't know. Sometimes the game hates me. It literally just broke on me, and I didn't know it for about, like, 10 minutes, so... just want to get off the elevator, then I can save, then I can swap you over. I think I'm back to the somewhat normal looking stages almost now.
Damn.
Well, by normal I mean all the freaky deaky box turrets.
Thanks. Yep. Fucking Wheatley, man.
Fucked up Wheatley. Test.
This statement is false. Don't think about it. Don't think about it. Don't think about it.
Yeah.
True. I'm gonna say true.
Your book. All right. Actually,